Shoot your shot.
Shoot your shot.
Wow, there's models.
I ain't gonna lie. No names involved. But some girl came up to me and said, oh, man, you know, I hate this girl. Blah, 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 blah. I'm the one that got her deleted.
Damn.
Not gonna say no names. Right. I'll tell you off camera
because you're wrong, dog. Fuck that.
No, we're not giving her no publicity.
No, exactly. And no free clout. No free clout. That's
some bullshit, though.
But I was like, damn. And I'm gonna keep it
yo,
a buck.
I got some real ass haters.
I'm gonna keep it a buck and a quarter.
ass haters.
When she told me that,
I got her.
I blocked her immediately.
Period.
What's up?
Yeah, shoot your shot.
Shoot your shot, dickhead.
Episode 10,
you dig?
We got Maddie a special guest, Maddie Bitting.
Yeah,
you're not supposed
vibe.
To introduce yourself.
Oh, damn, you switched up her whole intro.
Maddie Bitting in the building, you know the vibe.
She took charge, I like
it. She took charge, I like it. But we have a special guest today. You know, she's absolutely amazing on all social media platforms. Me personally, I think she's next up in a lot of different ball games and a lot of different fields. I'm very happy to have you on
the
show.
He means that too, because he told me that behind the scenes.
Absolutely.
So he definitely means that.
I'm definitely appreciative of you guys having me here. You know, I wanted to, you know, really lay out everything, and this is my opportunity.
Absolutely.
So
let's shoot a shot to you laying out everything. Let's start it off, Jumbo. Let's get that.
So Check did us dirty with the hen
Henny,
dog.
Right?
Yeah.
Like,
hen dog.
Like, Henny, I was like, oh.
I mean, I feel like we didn't have everything at this point.
Right.
Oh, man. I don't know. I didn't even know what to get back. So, you know, we had to just go back to the basics.
That's all
good.
You
know what I'm saying?
It ain't
I got
nothing.
My Coke on the side for the chaser.
Yeah, we're going to give her the pass just in case, you know.
You know, oh, and also... First lady on the podcast.
First lady
on
the podcast.
First lady on the podcast.
That feels special, okay?
Absolutely. Right.
Repping for the ladies, you already know.
Absolutely.
As you should.
So while Jumbo gets that all straightened up with the shots, first thing I want to ask you is, where are you from in general? Like, where are you from? Which, like, a little bit about yourself. Give me some game.
So I was born in Bristol Borough, Pennsylvania.
Okay, shout out to Bucks County.
Shout out to Bucks County.
Shout out to Bristol.
Queen of Bucks County, let me just put out there.
All right.
That's
just
scary. You heard it here first.
But yeah, so I was born and raised in Bristol Borough,
okay.
PA, and then I went to school in Doylestown.
Wow.
So
why'd you go to school in Doylestown?
I used my dad's address ever since the second grade.
What school is in Doylestown?
I went to Central Bucks East High School.
Oh, we used to fry Central
so,
Bucks in the town.
All right, well. Y'all trying to play me now.
Nah, I get it though, okay.
But anyway, like growing up in Bristol Borough versus going to school in Doylestown,
right.
It's like two different crowds.
Absolutely.
It was like two different worlds.
Absolutely.
I was like completely different than everybody that went to school. You know, when I got off that bus, I went back to Bristol.
Right.
They were all left in, you know, Doylestown.
Right.
So it was two different completely vibes. It was like going to two different worlds.
Right. And I think that might attribute to how you're able to, you know, be transparent and do things on social media, not really care what anybody thinks, and have a different type of personality. And we're going to get into that, but first, let's shoot our shot. Cue the music.
Oh, my God. If y'all could see this shot.
You
want
to dump it in there and just...
First one, you got to do it.
They're drawing on me, but this joint is filled to the brim.
See, I'm glad she's attested for this because y'all don't realize we've been drinking a whole bottle in an hour.
Wow.
In an hour. Whole bottle in an hour.
I don't know what I signed up for.
It's not three people,
it's even harder.
Yeah, it gets real.
So let's shoot our shot. Cue the music. Let's
get
go.
It.
Shoot your shot.
Disgusting. It's like
terrible. It just went down my neck.
Okay.
That's a huge.
Okay.
I ain't hear you.
Enough.
What'd you say?
Okay. So.
Thank you.
You said you went to school in Doylestown.
Right.
Okay. Now, after you got out of high school, I see you in Miami all day.
Right.
What's going on in Miami? What you got going on in Miami? Look like you're doing big things.
Oh, before
like
you do that, shout out your gram. Let them know.
Oh, look at. Okay.
Yeah, let them know.
So, shout out your gram.
All right. I'm going to show you real quick. Look.
Oh, you came in with your own merch
right,
and all
right,
this.
Shout
okay.
out to my business partner.
Shout
Farina.
Out to the marketing. Look at this.
FYH, follow your heart.
Shout out to FYH. All right,
we need some merch. What's
we need
up?
Some merch. Bring
Listen,
your shoot merch.
He's with it. Like he'll make you guys sweatsuits, whatever you want.
No, we need your merch.
Oh, well, that's coming soon. We gotta talk about that too.
Oh, we need your merch right. and we need his merch. Right. We're gonna rock with him too.
Right.
So since you're repping him on the podcast, we're gonna rock with him.
Right.
You know, show him some love.
Some love.
All you gotta do is hit us up. You can find it under the link in the
box. Yeah, we're gonna put everybody's links in there.
Instagram at I am maddiebitting.
Right.
Dope.
And you should follow the Snapchat too, because I feel like I'm more entertaining on Snapchat. I feel like I'm more personalized on there. You know, my Instagram's more for business. I try to keep it, you know, as business professional as I can while still show personality, because of course that's like huge on social media. You need to have personality, but Snapchat's my lane for like personality.
That's very interesting, because when I tell people that, I've been telling people that for years.
Right.
I would take off on Snap, and like people just don't understand, like, bro, you got to use the gram. I'm like, I use the gram for business. Like right. I use the gram for like podcasting, if I'm doing a photo shoot. Like I feel like I can't do as much.
Right. I feel the same way. Like sometimes I'm like, I don't really want to post this on Instagram because I don't want people to take it in the wrong way, where I feel as though my platform on Snapchat already knows what kind of...
See, you guys be getting into that edgy shit, that's why.
Yeah.
My Instagram, that's all I go off. I don't go off Snap too much, right. But I see why you guys do
right.
it, because...
Right, but honestly, she's not really that edgy from what I've seen
right.
On Snap, so I will vouch for that. I haven't been following for too long,
right?
But from the time that I have been following... Very personality, and we're going to get into that, but give me some more about this Miami escapade that you got going on.
So I wanted to move to Miami because I feel as though that's a really big hotspot city. A lot of people want to go to L.A. right away.
Mm-hmm.
Right. And what I always say is you should never move to L.A.
Until you got it.
Okay?
Facts.
You should never move to L.A.
They say, too, Miami's the second Philly. Don't they?
Yeah, well, they also, I agree with you. And a testament to that. And that's what I'm talking about. Like, for you to have that foresight this early
right.
just is amazing. Like, for me, my middle point before LA is going to be Vegas.
Right.
You know.
No taxes.
Yeah, I feel like Miami's more of a party town.
100%. Yeah. 100%.
LA, well, I don't know. Oh, then LA? Yes.
Yeah,
then
LA.
Nightlife is what made.
But Vegas is popping, too.
Oh, no,
Vegas and Miami are like the neck and neck.
No, I meant than L.A.
There's more mainstream rappers going to Miami rather than Vegas.
I agree.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
It's just all the events.
That all ties back to nightlife, though. Promoters, right. you know, club owners bringing in special guests.
Also, some great-ass strip clubs are in Miami.
Club 11. Mm.
Yeah,
oh,
Club 11.
Shit.
Shout out to them. They gave us the
crazy
red carpet. Shout out to them. Club Live, shout out to them. Shout out to a lot of places down there.
Mansion's still out there.
Rockwell, Mr. Jones, they're not as big as them. But
I don't know if it closed down, but we're not going to shout out Wild and Out fucking spot because they were like trash. I
never even heard of it.
Yeah, they have a spot on like Sunset Boulevard or somewhere weird. And it was nutty. It was funny.
Right.
But anyway, that's neither here nor there. But what are you doing in Miami? What's going on down there?
So basically, I wanted to move out there, obviously networking, you know, build my platform, whatever. And then I was in Bucks County Community College for a little bit.
Okay.
And then I got my associate's degree.
I went to Bucks County Community College also.
I think it's the smartest thing that anybody could do. That's all. I really want to put that out there. And like money, you really have to be financially smart. So, you know, going to community college was the smartest decision of my life. Got my associates. And then I was like, you know, I just want to move. I want to just, you know, expand this network. You know what I mean? My brand, you know, stuff like that. But, you know, I was like, I'm good in school, though. Like, my family's like, get it done now. You don't want to go back later, if anything. So I was like, all right. So I applied to University of Miami, right?
Okay.
Heard back in 2 weeks, got accepted.
Woo!
Oh, congrats to you.
Congrats to you.
That's major. Nobody can tell me anything, you know? Like,
yeah, to work hard. That's dope. To work hard in community college. And, you know, because, see, the thing about community college is, you know, once again, this is the Shoot Your Shot podcast, so we shoot your shot. If you got a goal to be a medical assistant, a doctor, whatever your situation is, and you need to start somewhere or you can't get approved at other places, start a community college. You know, the goal, everybody says do 2 years there, you could transfer wherever if you got your grades right.
Right.
Apparently,
this is true.
I regret not doing that because the fucking loans be
crazy. It's the same classes in the first 2 years. Meanwhile, you're saving thousands of dollars.
Yeah,
and
sure.
You're living from home and you're working and you're supporting yourself. You're making money while you're in school. You know what I mean?
Right. When you go away for college too, you paying for that rent.
I couldn't do no dorm shit either. So I was like, let me get my 2 years done and then I'll go in as a junior somewhere crazy. And I didn't even really think that I was going to do that.
She's talking that language now.
And then, when I got accepted, yo, I was like, I can't turn this down. Like the people I'm going to meet, you know what I mean? Yeah. The kids that are going to go to that school, their parents, absolutely. The connections
athletes
their parents
in that school,
have.
Everything.
Like, everything. I was like, I can't turn this down. Like
don't ever miss out on opportunities. You live once. Take everyone that's given to you to your best of your ability. And that's a fact.
And shout out to University of Miami. They gave me the president scholarship, $30,000. You know what I mean?
Oh, that's
so
major.
That John definitely was like the push to be like, all right, go ahead, bitch. Go.
And not only that, I just seen you post something about you made the UMTV vibe.
Right.
So what's that all about? What's going on with that?
God, I was so stressed out within that like 4 days of hearing back from my audition. Right. So I had an audition for...
We knew you were going to make it, by the way. I mean, I don't think too many girls got...
Right. That's why I was like, yo, if I don't make it, yo, they found out about my OnlyFans. And they're...
Damn.
I even took that
That's
John.
A good one.
I took that John out of my link tree. I was like, y'all fucking with my bread now, but I need this position.
That's
so
smart,
I was like,
though. You
100%.
You know
so I took
that shit
off.
Is smart.
Didn't even promote it. For that. Remember you asked me, why did you stop promoting
OnlyFans? Oh, and we're
going to
get there. And we're going
to
get there.
And I was like, I didn't really tell anybody, but that was why, you know, I needed to protect myself because, you
well,
know,
that's way
the
more
connotation.
Important.
Baby, wouldn't the school would have had to pay to see some shit?
Right. Because I would have been like, okay, like, you're gonna have to go pay and then feel dumped.
Right.
But other than that, I tried out.
But the crazy part is the way the FBI and schools are investigating
they
shit at this moment.
Yeah,
they
don't
give a they won't have to pay or they will pay.
Right.
Yeah, they don't
give
a damn at this point. They want to know what's going on.
And
they nosy
the
as hell.
Yeah.
They nosier than your parents
could,
at this point.
Sure.
With the money they're pulling in, they can buy everybody's
OnlyFans. No bullshit. The whole world's OnlyFans. No bullshit.
But yeah, so I applied. I auditioned for 3 different shows and I had the one audition was for the 2 shows that were like more business professional, like news.
Nah, you need the Ratchet Show.
Oh yeah. So
you need to go around talking your shit around campus.
But
let
I wanted
people know.
Right. I wanted to try out for 3 different
Hold on,
shows.
But
though.
Not to stunt your, you know, you can do anything, I believe.
Right.
But I'm just saying
you gotta start somewhere at the end of the day.
I appreciate y'all. No, I already know I needed that show with more personality.
Absolutely. That's
I
what
had
I meant.
Like a line of shows. I was like, all right, Off the Wire is the one I really want to get on. That's the comedy section.
Oh okay. Yeah. There we go.
So it's where you take news headlines, you make them into your own and you make them funny.
Okay.
And then I also you know, when I auditioned or whatever, I knew I killed that. I knew I killed it, the Off the Wire. The
well,
other two,
it was a great feeling. Right.
Yeah, when I applied for the other two, I knew I didn't do as hot. Like,
right,
I came out and I was like, I know
so
I did
So you got the funny one. You got the comedy.
I got my number one. I got
Shut
Off
up.
The Wire.
Yo, let's shoot another shot to get the position.
And for shooting your shot, too.
And for shooting your shot.
I got a little bit left. You got to fill it halfway.
Oh, no. Well, if you got a little bit left, just take... Oh, all right.
A little bit. You can add a little bit more.
But... See, that's the thing. You shot your shot.
Right.
For now, outside looking in, I seen you apply. I said she's going to get one of them positions.
Right.
I mean, I follow and talk to a lot of influencers, people in general, and not too many people have an outgoing personality like yourself. So I knew what it was hitting for from the gun bus. So at the end of the day, we're going to shoot a shot to that. And also, the reason why I was so big is because when I seen the set, I was
like,
damn,
God,
that's like fucking the news.
CNN, Fox, they have better equipment than CNN.
Yo, I mean, it's like the camera you see when you barely see behind the scenes
they
on
had
the news.
4 cameras that were half a mil or more.
Yeah, it was like the ones that like, hey, so
well,
we're
that's what we got.
Coming.
That's what we got right
they
now.
Right, this camera's worth more. I think. They had a teleprompter, you know, everything. They put me on the spot. They had like when during the audition, they had me read off the teleprompter.
Oh, I hate reading.
Oh my God, I'm
Let
pretty
me
good
add
at reading though.
No
but,
script.
Right. But I was reading it, and they had all these crazy ass words just to see how I handled it. Like, could I like keep going even though I got a little messed up?
Right.
So is that a network like on
UMTV?
Cable? Yeah.
So I have to find out a little bit more about it, but I feel as though if you have certain cable TV.
Okay.
You're
so
gonna
locally,
be able to watch it.
Locally down there, it's probably for everybody.
But they have a whole website and stuff like that. And, you know, I'm a broadcast journalism major. So,
oh, okay, even better.
Minor entrepreneurship, because you know, bullshit. But
that's like a beautiful segue.
Amazing for my resume.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because it's like I'm gonna have I'm gonna have the experience working with the machinery that other
working in front of the machinery, working with the machinery. Like I said, we're going to shoot a shot to the position.
For sure. Congrats.
Congrats. There we go. Appreciate y'all.
Hey,
shoot your shot.
Holy shit.
So what is your goals? Like, being that you got this now, you got journalism going for the degree. What's your goals through, like, with that?
With that?
Because I know you got to have multiple goals, I feel like.
Right.
I feel like you do.
I went to school. Because, again, I got that scholarship, you know, I had that financial aid. So I saw it as financially smart for me. You know, if it was like something crazy, I wasn't going to do that because I know what I'm capable of without a degree. But the thing is, I wanted a degree because I feel as though that'll put me in rooms that I might not be able to get into unless that's on my resume.
Facts. That's
so
true.
I know that I can do better than somebody who has a degree, even if I didn't get a degree. But I might not even have that conversation because I don't have that degree.
Yeah.
So I feel like I will have so much more opportunities, you know, showing that I'm versatile. You know,
you might get an internship somewhere.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And,
all that.
And like my plans weren't ever really to get a job with the degree necessarily because I know what I'm capable of outside of it. But if I get an internship that's paying me amazing, why not take that, you know, sign a contract for 2 years and still grow my brand on
but
the
outside?
But hold
on, even if the internship isn't paying you, internships are amazing. I had a few internships when I was coming up or in community college and stuff like that, and it's led me a long way.
Right.
But I also think more so when he asked about the goals, I would like to know what you want to do after college. Like, if what do you like what
real
will
estate.
Be your eye
real estate?
Well, okay. That's amazing. That's amazing too. But what would be your ideal field in the journalism world?
Or entertainment world.
That's like a really
loaded
hard question because I have so many.
But you gotta know though.
But
you gotta chase it.
You gotta know. Me? You gotta be real.
Can I have more of a specific question?
Because
I feel
have to
as
know.
If though, like I have so many different lanes of revenue I want to get.
Even
into.
Better. So we're gonna get off of that. I got a better question for you. So as far as social media,
right?
Now you're bubbling on social media. You know. I guess my question is, what do you want to do to take it to the next level, or what is your goal with social media? Is your goal to mainly capture audience, capture attention, get money, monetization? What is your goal with social media? Because before the TV, before the before the college, before anything like that, you were doing
avid
on social media.
Right.
So what is your goal with social media? And it's a loaded question. I'm gonna ask two parts of this. Did you ever think about doing stunts or like some people may say selling your soul on social media to get to the next level?
Right. Okay. First part, social media. The reason why I'm so avid on social media is I want to show people, like, you need to be confident in who you are. Okay?
Absolutely.
That's
all
the
girls
main,
listening, please hear this.
That's the main thing. Like, I really want people to know, like, if you're confident in who you are, nobody can break you down.
Facts.
You know what I mean? Like, if you're just, like, bold and you lay everything out on the table, nobody can really attack you.
Yeah,
when you're shy and you're, like, I put it this way, right? In high school, right? There's some kids that decided to be a lot quieter than others.
Absolutely.
And the reason why they decided to be quieter, you know, they might have homeboys that they're the funniest motherfucker with,
right?
But they're quiet in school because it's a social experiment. You know, they're sitting back because they don't want to have the confrontation. They're trying to do their school and get out,
right?
So my thing is, I've seen the quiet kids get made fun of. And the reason why they were quiet is so they didn't get made fun of. So my thing is, why not be exactly who you are if people are going to have an opinion anyway?
Absolutely.
For sure.
So I completely agree with what you said, by the way. But to point the question a little bit more further, okay, so let me just ask the other part. What is, like, what's your goal with social media? Or, like, what are you trying to do? Is it gain more followers? Because, okay, so let me just say, like, there's girls on social media or people on social media in general, not to point it anywhere, that just do it for the attention.
Right.
And I see you do a little bit of modeling too.
So
is social media a lane for, okay, I'm gonna sell my merch, or I'm a model my pictures. I want to become a runway model, because first of all, you got a million modeling pictures. I don't even. You got more modeling pictures than I've shot in my lifetime. So I'm like, the God,
content, I got
damn.
Content for days.
All right. That's something.
So with
social media, I think I know what you're trying to point at. With social media, the thing is, a platform can take you so many different ways.
Facts. There we go.
So my thing is, I can't really tell you exactly what I want to do with social media.
You're not
going
to confine yourself.
Because there's so much you can do.
Right.
So once you build that platform, you know what I always tell people? You're building a brand, okay?
Right.
And if you're sociable like me and you show a lot of personality, people are going to connect with you more.
Right.
So my thing is, you can build a brand, right? You can have like 100,000 followers.
Right.
And with that 100,000 followers, you can then open a business.
Big fact.
And then that business will take off. Then you take the revenue from that business, implement it into another bigger business. And it just let it keep rolling. You know what I mean? So as long as you're versatile on your platform, you can really take that love and support with anything.
Okay. So with that being said, to segue from that, is what do you... Did you ever think about doing social media stunts, like, i.e., we'll drop a few names, like a Bad Baby, a Whoa Vicky, to propel, even like...
Start talking shit and try to get them...
Yeah, start talking shit. You could, like, there's a lot of stunts.
Like troll, like...
Or get that...
To get the viral moment.
Because that's what everybody's to search for. I don't know, there's like a level of social media I don't know if you're familiar with. Like, when people got like the 5 to 10K, they're looking for that viral moment to take them to 100K, 150K.
I love this question, I already know what I want to say.
So, with that being said, a lot of people may, like, well, Vicky got on there talking all this shit, talking real loud, and now she tried to double back and say that's not really her, and whatever the situation, whether that is her or not, I don't know. You know, not to talk down on her at all or whatever the situation. Same thing with Bad Baby. Bad Baby didn't even know she was going to do it. She went on a show and just talked her shit, and it just turned her
and
into
just a piggyback.
Let's just say though, that was a publicity stunt.
Right,
like,
but now, they got sponsors. Now they got sponsors. They're getting money.
People come at her, and she took her mom out of a bad place and put her in a better place. You know what I mean?
She got a record deal.
Like, it's insane. It's insane. But
so did you ever think about doing that?
Right. Yeah. So
because you could go. Like, yo, fuck Whoa Vicky, fuck Bad Baby, fuck them, I'll smack the shit out you.
Right.
And make it go viral or something.
Yeah. I'm just really true to myself, I feel like. Like, I won't ever do anything that's not true to me. I won't ever do anything that I don't want, you know, to be brought up years ago and be like, yeah, like, I was just doing it for this. Like, everything I put out, I want to stand by. You know what I mean?
That's smart.
I want to continue to be like, yeah, like, 5 years later down the line, they show me a video from today. I want to be able to be like, yeah, that's still how I feel. So I won't ever do no clout chasing shit where it's like, I'm going to talk bad on somebody just in hopes to go viral. Like, no, that's another thing that's going to point me into the next direction is like, people care about this followers idea, right? The thing is, I've met so many different creatives because I model and stuff.
Right.
I met photographers with 20K, 50K, 100K, and then I've met photographers with under 1,000 followers and they produce better photos. I think a lot of people, you know, stress over this idea, I need more followers. I know girls that have 10 times more followers than me, but I still make more money off social media.
Followers not everything.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Especially if you have a business.
100%.
I know people who got $1 million businesses and they don't even have social
media. I'm going to drop a major key real quick. Shout out to Gary Vee. He always promotes this. It's not about your amount of followers. It's about the value you add to the followers.
Facts.
Right,
and, you know, you can have 100 followers that's paying you $1,000 a month based on this stuff that you're doing, or even $100 a month for that sake of the matter, you know, that you're making a major bag off of. Like, you could start a business up and make a business page and literally have 100 followers, but you're making $10,000 a month off of that, and you're making more than the girl on Instagram that's showing her ass with 100,000, 200,000, 300,000 followers, but you're adding value to people. And that's the longevity aspect, and that's the whatever the situation. And I also want to piggyback and go back to what you were saying about doing stunts and stuff like that. Like I said, we are Shoot Your Shot, and I don't mind also people that do stunts. Like the funny part is like a year ago, year and a half ago, I met Supreme Patty. I met a few other guys, and their whole goal was to let me get on a skateboard down Broad Street and fucking
fall on my face.
Fall on my face.
Like do some crazy shit. Like my that was their whole goal. Like,
and I love it. And I love it.
Now, that's cool.
And it made me think of like, oh shit, maybe I should be jumping off a building with no parachute.
But then again, somebody like Supreme Patty, like that goes with his brand.
Though. Right. He's that personality.
You know
for
what I mean?
Well, the thing about it is, that's not really him.
Right.
No. It seems like it, though, from the outside looking.
It seems like it from the outside looking.
But then that's where I think it starts to get tiring. Like, why not be
because,
you?
Hold on, but here's the thing.
Right. It's like, you're going to do this for the rest of your life.
But
like,
here's the thing.
And Instagram's not the only means of getting
absolutely,
money out
but
here.
Hold on, here's the thing.
100%.
But here's the thing. You can be fake. It's about the bag.
100%,
it's about the bag. So if, once again, we're not knocking anybody on how they shoot their shot. So if you're going to skateboard or be like, whoa, Vicky, and yell in 30,000 videos and make $1 million or $100,000. Hold on, but hear me out. If you make that money doing that and you're able to move your mom or whatever the situation is, you may look back on it and say, damn, that's not me, and try to rebrand later. But at the end of the day, that's a problem you'll have when you got the money.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it doesn't, like, I'm not knocking anybody, but I love, you know, the genuineness of how you're trying to go about it.
Right.
You know,
for sure. And it depends on what your end game is.
Right.
Like, I think music artists and stuff, they kind of have to really think about doing some shit like that.
Right.
Because you're going for a popularity contest when you're trying to be an artist or something.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So you might have to do some shit like that.
Right.
But if you're really trying to do something else, you don't have to. It depends on where you're trying to take it.
I mean, like for example, you know, we all follow Boonk when he was like stealing stuff from people.
When I touched down to LA, I seen Boonk sitting on the fucking joint. High as shit.
Yeah, and like at the end of the
lacking
day,
heavy lacking. But that's I didn't even
you
say
thought
what's
about
up.
It. You thought about it.
Hell yeah, I thought about
it. He thought about it.
But I was like, shit, turn roll real quick. Turn to grandma real quick.
Right.
Yeah, but
nah, I wouldn't do no shit like that. But yeah. it was cool though.
But absolutely, like, and that's the thing. Like, it just becomes, you know, me personally, I'm about the bag, so I don't give a damn. I'll go on OnlyFans and put everybody, and we'll get it popping or whatever the situation may be and get it lit because of the bag.
But my question is sometimes you have to ask, like, is the bag worth really going so far away from who you really are? You know what I mean?
Well, I say because I'm not me broke neither. So we're you know, I don't know where the fine line or the medium is.
Right.
I can't be me broke and I'm not really this. So there's a medium there.
Right.
And
I guess it depends on the situation. What you want to do.
If you're like, okay, I need to do this because I don't really have any other choice.
But
then,
by the way, this is only
this is
only conversations for people with no talent.
Right.
Right. Like, you're in college, you're doing the right thing.
Right.
So, you know.
It's only a conversation with people with no talent. If you feel like you have talent or you think you're good at what you do, you could just stick in your lane and be diligent and you'll make it.
Right.
Diligence will always.
But that goes, it goes, like, you don't have to do nothing crazy either. Like, for example, you familiar with Danny Lay?
No.
I'm terrible at names, so when you guys name drop,
she's
I'm
a rapper.
Be like,
she's pretty big now. She's on Def Jam and stuff where she was.
Okay.
But she was signed to Def Jam for a few years, right?
Right.
About 100,000 followers. And then one day she jumped out the car to the Drake Kiki John.
Right.
And went viral.
Right.
Now, she didn't sell herself or do nothing nutty, but she blew up off of that. You know what I'm saying? So that's an example where you don't got to sell your soul.
Right.
And you can still go viral.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And honestly,
I also feel like a lot of people are sitting there like, all right, what's the next viral video? What's next viral video?
Absolutely.
All day.
That's
all they do.
The top
she
people
was doing that
for
a while.
Right, like, you're reaching, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Listen.
Just grow it gradually, you know?
And I think you could thoroughly do it, though, without selling your soul.
Right. Here's the thing.
At the end of the day.
So everybody that is big on social media or, like, in the midway of big on social media realize that the brands and monetization all depend on the number. So engagement and everything. So what happens is, once you realize, okay,
had to re-up real quick.
So when you realize, okay, so, like, let's just say you got 50,000 followers and Fashion Nova says, here's $400 where the stuff
make and a weekly post.
Make a weekly post, and, right. and but they'll also say, oh well, if you might say, oh I want more, but they'll say, oh well, if you had 100,000 followers, we would pay you $3,000.
Right.
So yeah. You're like, oh well, hold up,
let me show you my engagement real quick.
Yeah, let me show you my engagement. And matter of fact, let me turn up my followers real quick.
Right.
You understand? Same thing with flat tummy tea, and same thing with a lot of these things. It all depends on numbers. And the crazy part about it is that's where people get lost.
Yeah.
And 100%. But that's the bad part. And I also see the other side, because to me, social media is just another TV show, and it's just all acting.
Right.
So once you think of it that way, from an influencer standpoint, I'm not talking about from a fan standpoint. A fan should, you know, I believe a fan or a supporter will say, I like to use the word supporter better, will believe in you and believe you got it going on and whatever the situation may be. But from another influencer standpoint, I looked at everybody like they're acting. Right. And I might like Denzel better than I like Tom Cruise, but at the end of the day, it's the same thing. You might, you know, I might turn on Die Hard one day, or I might turn on
or a comedy artist goes up there and tells jokes. He, in real life, they might just be regular.
Okay, so and that's a good segue to my next point. So now, how did I know you do your party promoting thing, and this goes back to social media. So first of all, let me get into let's start from the beginning. How did you get into party promoting? And what's that, and what's your goals with that, and what's up with the party promoting thing? Because I do party promoting also.
Right, so...
And what was your biggest party? So first, how did you get into it, and what was your biggest party so far?
Okay, so I got into party promoting simply because I'm a party girl.
Absolutely.
100%, I'm always about, like...
Once again, genius.
I'm that one girl, you know, at the party, like, yo, can you throw back real quick for the snap, real quick? Like,
right.
You know what I mean? I'm always about lituation, like, I'm always about good vibes, getting lit, you know, right. Stuff like that. Not necessarily even having to drink or smoke, just like get togethers, fun ass vibes in a room. So,
right.
You know, I've always loved that. So I was like, you know what? How can I make money off this?
Big facts. And to think that this early is, once again, amazing.
And right back to Bucks County, you know, growing up real young, I always had all the waves. You know, my phone was blown up Friday, Saturday through Sunday. Like, yo, I have 3 different addresses. We're going to go here first, then there. And I was the type to hop right on Snap, like, yo, what's good?
Right,
like,
right.
We're here tonight, or DM me for the address, right, whatever. Right. I was always
You were doing it then.
I was always bringing people together, always sending out the waves. Anybody who knows me, they'll say, she always had the best parties, period. Like, even if they weren't my parties, I had people call me like, yo, I got a free crib this weekend.
Right.
Make it happen.
Right.
I'd be like, all right, bro, we're going to charge $10 at the door. I'll give you 50%. Period.
Facts.
Like, fire. So when that started happening, you know, I went to actually my partner's content shoot. It's called a content shoot. It's where photographers, designers,
and models come together,
you know, absolutely, what I mean, and create content. Awesome, amazing idea.
Like a warehouse vibe or like a good photography spot.
Yeah, that's like smart. A nice studio or whatever.
Nice studio or
so,
whatever.
Basically, I went to one of his events and I was like, yo, like, I got capital to, you know, to invest. You know what I mean? I already have such a huge network. I already know so many girls who want to do what I do. Let's get this shit popping.
Right.
Mm. So, you know, we became partners, and then I started throwing content shoots. That was like one of my first actual events behind my name. And then I started to promote for all types of different clubs. I remember the one night, Vanity Grand.
Ooh,
I got carried out. The night I promoted, I got carried out by the fucking security guard over his back.
Were you working with Sean Miles at that point?
Or I believe so. That name actually rings a bell. Sean so it Miles could have been guy, him who made me my...
Vanity Grand.
Yeah, somebody had made me my flyer.
I've
was like, yo, here's your
that.
Night.
Absolutely.
Like, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
So then I was like, oh, okay. Like, and I love the club scene. So I was like,
and
all right.
And by the way, if y'all don't know Vanity Grand was like...
Is this still... It's not called that no more, right?
Nah, that's closed. There's too many shootings and stuff like that. But I'm talking about Vanity Grand probably held 1,000 people. And it was a strip club.
Upstairs, downstairs.
Yeah. That's
holes
where you see Floyd Mayweather
bar.
Being that John, fucking Rick Ross.
I remember the first time I went in there. It was raining.
The first time I met Cardi B. Shout out to Cardi B and Vanity Grand.
Right.
Absolutely.
So
and
you,
it was before she was popping.
So do you have anything coming up that you wanted to?
Yeah, I do actually.
Okay, go ahead. Promote
right, so
what you got coming up.
November 28th, 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. We might actually extend it to 10 p.m. because we have so many models and photographers and designers who want to be involved. So I have another one of those content shoots coming up. And I'm super excited about this one because we're calling it Philly Love. We're calling it Philly Love because I see a lot of, and I know you guys are going to agree with this 100%, even in what you do. For instance, I see a lot of models get competitive with other models. I see a lot of designers get a lot competitive with other designers. I see a lot of photographers get competitive with other photographers. So my thing is, you know, we're all from the same place. We're all doing the same thing. You know, we love what we do. So why not share when you love somebody else's work? You know what I mean? So I'm calling it Philly Love because I don't want any influencers, anybody who's a part of this event to come and have the idea that this is just for me. It's not just for you. This is where we're going to build off each other. If you're not tagging every single person involved in the picture you're posting, if you're not tagging the people who held the event, you know, got the venue, brought all these people together, you know, after our first event, I've watched people, girls, and again, followers aren't everything, but I've watched girls go from 2K to 10K after one of our events because of the networking that we provide. We're putting them in a room with so many different photographers and designers and models, you know, they're going to go talk to the models. The models are going to talk and say, hey, like, I've worked with this photographer. You should work with him. I've worked with this photographer.
Now, is this something you got to pay to go to?
Yeah, so we do charge. We do charge, you know, we're paying for the venue. You know, we're bringing everybody together and stuff like that. So we always charge a door fee for everybody. The only people we don't charge, and we actually just started making it like this. At first, we did charge photographers, but now we're at the point where, like, we have such a solid group of photographers. We're not charging photographers because at the end of the day, they have to edit the pictures.
They have to put the work in.
Not that everybody else isn't putting work in, but they have to put the work in after the fact, not just at the event. They have to sit down on their computer, and if they're, you know, a really good photographer, sometimes editing takes up to an hour just for one picture.
Especially depending
on the model. You know what I mean?
Especially if the girl wants a fat ass and she don't got one.
Right. Extend that jaw a little bit.
Every girl
Make it look natural.
Every girl I've ever shot say, oh, I got a little cellulite in the back. Smooth that out a little bit. Smoothing brushes.
That's amazing what they could do now. That shit is so crazy.
Absolutely. Shout out to the smoothing brush.
definitely a vibe. Philly Love's definitely going to be a vibe. Like, I'm super excited because I...
Sign up.
Hold on. So I seen on social media you had an event in Bensalem coming up with like a rapper or something like that. What's going on with that?
Right. So shout out DJ Zeke and Zach Tyler. They called me and they were like, yo, you know, we know you're good at hosting events, handling the money, the business end of it, basically. Right. You know, they called me and they were like, yo, we want to throw this event. You know, we have everything in line. We just kind of need your structure.
Right.
And I was like, I got y'all. You know what I mean? Music's my ears because Zach Tyler is actually somebody that, you know, I want to work with in the future because I have the money to invest in events and I can invest in a rapper, say he's 10K for a show.
Right.
You know what I mean? Pay that 10K, sell the tickets.
You see how she's talking that language.
Shout out Zach. Right. He's definitely doing his thing.
And hold on. Definitely doing it. And that's actually, I want to bring that up. He's super young in the game and stuff, right? When I posted that I was going to help run this event and they put my name on the flyer and stuff, they asked me, like, you want your name on the flyer? I was like, yo, you want to put it on there? You can. They put it on there, you know, more traction. You know, I have my own
price
fan base
went up.
And stuff. Price went up.
Coward boy.
People knew it was going down. But basically, like, you know, as soon as I posted that, the crazy part about it is I have a lot of haters. So I know what it feels like to have a lot of haters. As soon as I posted that, yo, so many people called me like, yo, you're working with blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? Like, oh, da, 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 da. And then started giving me their opinion. I'm like, listen. I was like, you have a lot to say, but
I don't care about none of that. Back to the bag.
He has connections y'all never even, you know, could even get. You know what I mean? Like,
what'd you guys offer me?
Right? So it's not even just about that either, because I want us to grow together. Like, I want to put him onto what I got going on too. You know, I want to make it a partnership, not like I'm over here like, oh, you got this, I want that. No, we build off each other. But the thing was with that was I had so many people call me like, yo, like, he's young, he's this, he's blah, 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 blah. I'm like, yo, I remember when I was his age and I was hustling just like him.
Facts.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
and I have nothing but love for that kind of shit. You know what I mean? Like, I saw that, I was like, y'all are hating, but like, this man isn't on his way. He's on his way to something great. You know, the connections he has.
Shout out to him, but I got a question for you. So this is going to help other people that may want to do the same thing as you. I have a comparison I want to make, but I also first want to start here. I heard you say a few times that you have the capital to do what you need to do. I think for everybody, including myself, how were you able to get capital, or what's your main source of income, or not to get too deep into what you got going on.
Right.
But what is your main capital?
Counter pockets, dog.
Nah, I'm just saying, like, for example, like, I know how to throw parties. And nice.
You trying to get me in trouble, dog? It's like, nah, I'm kidding.
Well, if you can't talk about it, that's
no,
cool,
no,
too.
No, no, no,
because,
no.
Like,
we can get into it.
Like for example, you know, I'm throwing a mansion party soon. The house is $2,500 to rent. That's nothing to myself, but for most people, they wouldn't be able to do that just alone.
Right.
So if you're saying you're willing to pay $10,000 for a party or a rapper, I would just like other people to know and not feel like they can't do that. And I wanted them to know, like, this is how I've done it.
Right.
I started from here. I started maybe, you know, marketing on OnlyFans. I was getting this. I was going that. I was getting there.
Right.
I started this way. So
yeah, I'll tell you where capital came from. And then I'll also tell you, if you want to get into what I'm doing,
right,
where to start. So
boom. That's why we're here on. We giving them, we making them shoot their shot. So we got to shoot it, shoot a shot. You feel me?
Yeah. Hey. But keep that thought in mind.
Though.
I was kind of hoping y'all forgot about that part. You better half fill me again. My body's already warm. I'm feeling right. warmer
you,
up in here.
You take what you need to take, but yeah.
Perfect.
We got to keep this bottle flowing though. You feel
Absolutely.
Me?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And, y'all gonna make me take this shot and then talk about it.
I'm not drunk yet, so.
And hold
on. You might have to repeat the question after the shot.
And hold on. That's why I asked the question, because I want people to shoot their shot.
Right. Right.
And, you know,
that's what we're about. We're trying to school people.
And that's why I couldn't wait to come on here, because you guys are supporting people's grind. You know, you're broadcasting it.
Let's shoot a shot to shooting your shot.
Shoot the shot.
To Maddie.
Shoot a shot.
Wow.
Woo! Yeah.
Y'all got me drinking Henny. My friend's gonna come straight for my neck, because they're gonna be like, bitch, we always wanna drink Henny. You always like, nah. And I'm over here.
Oh, shoot your shot.
It's a different type of time.
Right.
You know, I had to adjust for y'all.
Absolutely. But anyway, back to the capital question. How'd you start up, and what's going on with the capital?
Shout out to my mother. That's my biggest motivation.
Shout out to Mama Dukes.
She is a hustling ass woman, you know
I
what I mean?
I love that, like, you kept it so real.
Like, she, you know, she had four kids. My mom didn't have a car till like 32 years old. She used to drive. My brothers and sisters call me spoiled, you know what I mean? Because I'm the last child. So, you know, my mom became a massage therapist later on in life. Mm. So when she became a massage therapist, you know, our life changed a lot.
Okay.
And a lot of my my siblings are like, yo, you're spoiled. I'm like, listen, mom just has a different life now. They're used to getting driven on a bike to their doctor's appointment.
Right.
Real shit. Like,
damn.
Real shit. Like, my mom didn't have a car until her 30s, didn't have her own phone until her late 20s. Like, my mom was all about her kids, you know what I mean? So I watched from a young age, like, her hustle, you know what I mean? And like,
right. That's what it's all about.
So
same thing with my mom. Shout out to Mom Dukes.
Right. Mamas are always important.
Absolutely.
But you know, from a very young age, I had this work ethic. You know what I mean? I always wanted to get money. I loved money. You know what I mean?
Same.
Like, that was me. Right. Like, I was, like, always, like, I was the little girl making little bracelets sitting out on my porch, like, yo, buy
hustling.
These junks. Like,
right.
So, anyway, at 14 years old, you know, normally you can't get a job, you know, because you have to be 16 to get your working papers, right?
Right.
I used to go to Chick-fil-A in Oxford Valley all the time. Little obsession for me and my mom. We used to go like four times a week, whatever.
I used to be in there too.
And you know, the people that walk around and like
give the samples out?
Well, they're just like, oh, can I take your tray? Or how you doing? Let me like wipe this up, whatever.
Yeah, type shit.
He was like, you know, we do take some 14-year-olds, you know, if she's looking for a job. Because we're there all the time. We're always mingling with them, whatever. So then I got that job at 14 years old. Oh, I was the hypest 14-year-old in my Chick-fil-A uniform. You know what I mean?
Shout out to you at 14. Damn.
Right. So I worked from 14 to 16. I saved all my money. I was a money saver. And you got to understand, from 14 to 16, I was living like I was 20. So I needed to support them weekends. I needed to keep up. Like, most of my friends were all older, graduated, whatever the case may be. I had to keep up, you know?
Yep.
So from 14 to 16, I always saved, but I always had fun. And then
you don't have to give us a time frame, but just I get it.
Right, yeah. But then once I got my working papers, it was just job, job, job. And my main thing was delivery driving, yo.
I was a delivery driver too. Yeah. Shout out to Aaron Rinaldi and the pieces.
Hustlers know right. where the money's at, right? So
absolutely.
I was doing delivery driving, and it would be hilarious because like my boss fucked me, so like I could wear whatever I wanted to work, whatever the case. I could wear whatever I...
Okay, go ahead. Sit.
You wanted me to go? Yeah.
I said, what?
Yeah, you're always trying to, like... Yeah.
Go ahead,
nah.
No.
I wore whatever. I basically knew the whole system. So, like, right. You know what I mean? Like, I taught the girls the system when they would have new girls come in, blah, 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 blah. I was a delivery driver, whatever. I could wear whatever I want. So, it'd be funny as shit. I would
get
go to
them
the door.
Tips.
Right.
Wait, I would go to the door... And a motherfucker would expect an ugly-ass old man or some shit.
Right.
They would open the door. There's me. They didn't want to feel embarrassed. I'm a young, pretty girl. They're like, oh, shit, I forgot something. Hold on. They would run back in, grab a $5 or $10 tip.
Shout out.
I thought so.
I used to love the $5 or $10 tips.
Tell me why all the girls now are doing DoorDash now.
Yeah.
And Uber Eats.
That's a nice little side hustle. That's, again, money to get and reinvest into whatever your main goal is.
Sure. So then, but you got to have that main goal.
Right.
Continue.
And then I got into serving as soon as I turned 18 years old. I went and got ramp certified. Shout out to Buffalo Wild Wings. I learned all about my drafts, you know, like imports, you know, your domestics, you know, stuff like that. So I learned all about that game. And then I was like, ooh, okay. And then I started going. I went from Buffalo Wild Wings. I worked there for 3 months, okay? I knew I just needed something on my resume. I got into Buffalo Wild Wings by just lying, saying I served somewhere else.
Right.
So I got in there because it's like, not necessarily a lower class, but it's not a high-end restaurant.
Right.
Yeah,
so then I went from
in and
there.
Out shit.
Right. And then I had that on my resume, was ramp certified, went to a nice restaurant after 3 months of working there. Like, you know, hopped from that and went to the next one.
That's the hustle.
Right.
That's the hustle. Say once always, again, shooting your shot.
Right. As a server, you always want to look at the menu. Whatever has the highest prices, you know
you
what I mean?
You want to sell that.
You want to go to that restaurant with the highest paying,
Del
you know,
Frisco's.
Entrees. Right. Stuff like that, because, you know, at the end of the
Berkeley
day,
Pound.
You're going to have people showing love on tips. And two, the check's going to be high. And normally you get 20% of it, whatever.
Yep.
So, you know, serving something I've always done, always hustled. You know, I'd be the server there till 11 at night and then go into the club right after because, you know, I needed to get that chicken first.
Right.
Boom.
And then,
So, okay, great. And that's an amazing story. So, ladies and gentlemen, when you want to get what you got to get to, Jadakiss said it best, you can't save money, you're useless, and all you're going to ever have is excuses. So that's a fact. So, you know, you got to save your money. You got to do what you got to do. You know what I mean? Because I be seeing you on the gram counting some bands and you got money phones and all types of stuff going on. So I just wanted to ask that question for the Maddie Bidding followers.
And my Bucks County avid followers, you already know, like they know a little bit more. But we can't get into some things, but you already know, my name holds weight, period. And anything.
Say that. So I'm going to get into this then, okay? Me personally, I thought you might have been lit on OnlyFans.
Right.
Okay? Now it's time to segue from getting money into social media, women, men, and OnlyFans.
Right.
Okay, so now I seen you had one. At first, I never followed or anything. I just, you know, wanted to, you know, just support you in any type of way I could. And, you know, we got it. You know, I just seen you doing that. I'm like, oh, she probably killing it. Because I know what that top 4 or 5% look like. And I'm like, oh, my monthly check can hold a money phone, too.
Right.
And so I was just wondering, you know, so first things first, I just want to give your thoughts on OnlyFans. What's going on with your OnlyFans? What's your thought on OnlyFans? And basically, let's start there.
Right. So first things first, OnlyFans was actually made for entrepreneurs.
Okay.
So for instance, I always use
one real quick. But you're saying that's not your main source of income, though, right?
No.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. Now go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. So. OnlyFans is definitely a side hustle. It could become bigger, you know, as my platform grows. But right now, it's just like a side hustle. And I'll get into why I got into it and who introduced it to me. But first thing I want to say is OnlyFans was made for entrepreneurs, okay? So, for instance, I always use this analogy. You could be really good in the stock market, mm-hmm. and you could post your tricks on there. You can post videos about, you know.
For sure. We talked about that.
I told Jumbo he needed to do his mixing videos on OnlyFans.
Right. Because it was originally made for entrepreneurs to show their skills. skills and broadcast their skills so that their platform could pay to watch and
YouTube,
hear these tricks.
That
and,
people could pay for.
Right, exactly.
Sure.
Basically.
So it was an amazing idea. Whoever made OnlyFans,
they should have made
they're
that.
Rolling
they,
in it.
They
you
shouldn't
know
have
mean?
Had
they're
that
rolling
name.
In the
Absolutely.
Money. They're rolling
and
in
tell
it.
Tell Apple to let them get an app.
They're getting 20% of my shit. Like,
wait,
yeah,
every
what,
time.
What, wait, what happened recently? Where they're not paying as good or some shit.
We'll get into that. We'll get into that. I definitely want to talk about that. But
keep going, though.
So,
yeah.
So what had happened? This gets into a whole nother thing too. So I was posting my professional pictures on Instagram, right?
Mm-hmm.
And as soon as I turned 18, I was able to start showing more skin. You know, when you're under 18 and you model, you can only do so much.
We don't want no child pornography.
Right, right, right. So as soon as I turned 18, you know, I started.
No Epstein's in the
right,
building.
Right.
Absolutely.
I started expanding, you know, as soon as I turned 18, I was like, you know, I've never been shy. You know what I mean? I look at the body as a art form, you know what I mean? So I never looked at it as any other way than like professional photos that I would literally hang in my room for my kids to see. You know what I mean?
Right.
So
some rose from Titanic type shit.
Yeah, like just some sexy shit. Like that's right. Just like, wow, like anybody, they'd be like, yo, let me get that for an album cover. Yo,
right,
let me put that in my studio. Like stuff like that, whatever. So I got into the implied photography and nude photography. And if you don't know what implied is, it's like where you're not
naked all the way, but you're kind of showing skin to imply that you're naked.
Exactly.
Or
like you're implying that you're about to get naked or you're just showing a little bit more skin, but you're covering the parts that matter, stuff
Absolutely.
Like that. So started getting into implied and nude, and I was posting on my previous Instagram page. So I had an Instagram page that was taken down or whatever. So
haters.
Yeah, I think I was following you on there, and then you disappeared.
Haters. That's just
haters.
Period. Let me just say that. So basically, I was posting these pictures, right? When I started posting the more implied and the nude, oh my God, Bucks County blew up, yo. Like, that was probably one of the biggest months for me. The first picture that I post showing a lot of skin, yo, my shit was everywhere.
Engagement
on a beam. Glad you said that.
My profile visits, 15K. I had 6,000 followers. 15,000 profile visits.
So,
and I have the screenshots too.
No,
I believe you.
So here's the thing, but and I'm gonna let you continue, but I just have to expound on that real quick. I deal with a lot of OnlyFans women all the time, and girls that have a lot of followers and the girls that have really no followers or no subscribers. The main thing that separates the girl that has a lot of followers from the girl that doesn't have any is that the girl that has a lot of followers don't care. And that's the thing. When you can market to your, first of all, as simple as this. Any guy that you know is going to want to see you naked for a small fee.
Right.
Simple as that. If I could pay $12 to see you naked.
Right.
So here's the thing. You know, you're not thinking about, we don't care about the $12 because a lot of girls, you know, once again, we come back to the haters. So you know, you might have a old hater from your town that might say, oh, she's fucking showing her titties for $12.95.
Report.
Or whatever the situation is.
I got a group chat sending my fucking Instagram post and like, yo, let's all report this. Hopefully it gets deleted tonight.
Oh, they hating.
It was bad at that point.
Right.
I want to get into that a little bit more, but go ahead.
But basically what I was saying is once you start to get in that realm of not caring, the monetization off of OnlyFans and like engagement just becomes a different thing. Because like, you know, the main audience that people have is their friends. And it's just simple as that. And if you care about what your friends think, you're not going to really make a lot of money in the long run.
Right.
And I tell everybody this often, and you know, hopefully, you know, whatever the situation is, once you start to care about what your friends think, it you're gonna miss out.
Right.
Now, if you got opportunities or jobs or whatever the situation, that's a whole different ballgame. But if you're talking about if you care what you know Joe Schmo think that you knew from 12th grade or 11th grade or from went to high school,
that
with,
comes back to the confidence thing too, and also like really just like building a brand that you support. You know what I mean?
Right.
So like you don't have to feel that way.
Right.
But like I definitely want to get into how I started OnlyFans.
So go ahead, get into that. So I just wanted to just put that out there. People that don't care about what people think will make way more money.
They tend to blow up 10 times more because
absolutely.
Obviously they're showing a little
more.
Bit extra. Yeah,
and
they're
doing
extra.
It ain't about them friends. It's about
the
one.
And I also want to get into like, you know, I don't judge those females that do that.
And that also
either.
Goes back to the beginning where you're willing to do stunts to get to where you want to go
to. Right, exactly. So we'll get into a little
bit
of that.
So that's the same narrative, you know, on a different type time. But anyway, go back to what you were saying.
So
how'd you start OnlyFans?
So, you know, I started posting these pictures and then they were getting reported. Boom. Instagram would say, oh, we're deleting your post for going against community guidelines. Meanwhile, there's models.
I ain't gonna lie. No names involved. But some girl came up to me and said, oh, man, you know, I hate this girl. Blah, 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 blah. I'm the one that got her deleted.
Damn.
Not gonna say no names. Right. I'll tell you off camera.
Say her name, dog. Right. Fuck that.
No, we're not giving her no publicity.
Nah, no, exactly. And no free publicity. Clout. No free clout.
That's some bullshit, though.
But I was like, damn. And I'm gonna keep it
yo,
a buck.
I got some real ass haters.
I'm gonna keep it a buck and a quarter.
ass haters.
When she told me that,
I got her.
I blocked her immediately.
Period.
Because it
we
was
don't
like,
fuck with no haters.
And I because like it's just like if that's your sole intention now mind you, now you might know just from what I'm about to say, but no one else would know. But she was like, yo, I did photo shoots for her. She didn't pay me and this and that, whatever the situation is. Mind you, she gave me this whole rundown. And
it was a female?
It was a female.
I've only shot with three female photographers.
Well, we'll talk about that off camera because we're not gonna give her no clout. But at the end of the day, she said this to me and I blocked her immediately. And it was just like the fact that she wanted one question.
She's not like a real professional photographer, right?
Hell no.
No, and I already know. Already know who, and she already admitted to me like, yo, yeah, I was definitely reporting your pictures.
This was she told me already.
Yeah,
I but the know fact that she felt like that was the conversation she wanted to have with me, I'm like, dog. And mind you, I don't know this girl. I met her through a mutual friend. I went to a cookout.
Starts with K.
But look, yo, fuck all that.
Absolutely.
See?
Y'all funny as shit.
I knew off the jump.
Mind you, I don't know you, and I didn't know her.
Right.
And she's telling me what she did to you.
Well, you know she gonna watch this, John.
Great. Let me just clarify one thing. Never was a photo shoot. Shardy was holding my iPhone picture, getting my my flex up.
You ain't gotta explain yourself.
Like, that's part of being my friend. You
know? We're not gonna expose nobody. I just wanted to say.
Right. No.
Let me ask both of y'all, though. What's the deal with Instagram? Because I be seeing some girls and I be seeing nipples. I ain't gonna lie.
On Instagram?
That's what I wanted to say.
I see a lot of camel toe on Instagram. Wait,
so how's that work?
So listen.
My homie Danny Banks. Oh man, I don't understand how she gets get yo. Her bikini is the size of a two.
The girl I'm talking about got six million followers.
Danny Banks got three.
The more followers you got, the more leeway you got. So listen, let me explain this. Okay, right?
That's not true though.
I'll tell you how it is though. Hold up. They got managers. They got teams that are going to be able to get in contact with somebody important from Instagram where they can. You can't.
That's
email
different if
Instagram.
You're verified.
They got too many things going on. If you know an in man.
Ho! Time out.
Right.
Remember, we had this big ass conversation about a publicist. All people that wanted to start up, you know, their social media. The most important thing is not a manager. It is a publicist.
Yeah.
The person that can get in contact with Instagram that has a good relationship. You might have to pay them $1,000 or $2,000. But what they're going to do is get you verified on Instagram, no matter how much your followers are. No, whatever the situation.
So they call Instagram and say, let that jaw rock.
Basically.
Because that shit is still up there.
Connections are everything. That's all I really got
to
say.
No. What happens is, though, like when a post gets taken down or you get shadow banned or whatever the situation is. For example, i.e. Tory Lanez. Tory Lanez did his quarantine radio.
Yeah, he got banned.
He got banned just naturally, the algorithm. And
then Boosie got banned.
And well, it's different with Boosie because he isn't, he's a little old school, so I feel like he didn't have the end with Instagram.
Tory Lanez.
Publicist is new school,
yeah,
apparently.
For sure.
You know, they got on the phone with Instagram, and next thing you know, the guy that created Instagram came out and said, I'm listening to the next joint. We're unlocking his account today. Whatever the situation may be. And we're going to get into that later.
To the point, it's like, I see, like, these girls showing that. So I was just wondering.
Right. So,
why is their shit up there?
Right.
It's crazy.
So the thing is, there's some girls that are able to post that because they don't have that hater community reporting.
Yeah.
So my thing is, I was getting all these pictures reported. You know what I mean? I'm down to like probably one report left until my fucking profile goes. You know what I mean? Like,
I feel that. I went through 17 Snapchats at this point.
Right. So anyway, I had I was posting pictures. They were getting reported, getting taken down. I was posting on social media like, yo, haters are going to hate. You know what I mean? I got to push through it. You know what I mean? Mm. Sometimes I would even try to repost the picture because I loved it so fucking much, and it would still get reported. So
can't you blur some shit or something, or
I wasn't even showing what I'm not allowed to show. It's just the point. The fact was that so many people were reporting. It's like Instagram really.
I think Instagram got to change that. Yeah, 100%.
They need to monetize that a little bit better because I had so many people reporting.
Monitor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Monitor. What did I say? Monetize.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, monitor, yeah.
I'm just making
I'm like, did I say something wrong? Like, I'm a college girl. I can't, you know?
But you had the right intentions.
You had the right intentions, though, for sure.
Okay, thanks, guys. Thanks for embarrassing me really quick.
No, nah, you good.
No, no, stop. I'm kidding. So, anyway, whatever. So, this male model inboxed me on Instagram, right? And he's like, yo, like, have you ever thought about making an OnlyFans? And at the time, because, you know, again, it was made for entrepreneurs, and he's the one who opened my eyes to that. You know what I mean?
Right.
He DM'd me, and I was like, nah, like, I never thought of OnlyFans because, you know, I don't see myself portraying myself like that. And right. I, again, thought it was only for, like, porn stars majority.
Right.
So, so then basically, he gave me the rundown. He was like, listen, you can post literally pictures of your dog. If you have the fan base that's going to pay for it,
absolutely. Then
it doesn't matter what you're posting.
Shout out to him for understanding that.
100%.
So, and for, hold on, for the people that don't use OnlyFans, so you don't see it before you buy it?
No, so you would have to pay to subscribe, then you get to see all the posts. Or I've also seen like Tana Montague, I don't know how to say her last name, but she has an OnlyFans and I follow it, and you can follow it for free. But you have
shout out to Jimmy Smacks, the number one male influencer. Oh my God, his OnlyFans is amazing. It's free, and I think I'm starting to think that's the way to go.
Okay, so you can follow for free, but you have to pay to unlock each
video.
Post. So that's a way to kind of like literally make more money in a way because you're paying per
post. Absolutely.
Meanwhile, when you do the monthly thing, you're seeing all the users post for that monthly fee. Right. Meanwhile, they're follow me for free. And
if they're not impressed, I'm gonna post some free stuff next month, but then
you're gonna have to unlock the stuff that you really want to see. So that's definitely a good way to go. But anyway, I looked into it after he said that. He's like, you can literally post pictures of your dog. That was music to my ears. I was like, I don't have to post these things. He's like, no, you can literally, like I said, post pictures of your dog and people will pay to see, like, if you have the fan base for it. So I was like, he's like, you know, all these pictures that you're getting reported and deleted, you could post without the scribble, you know what I mean? And get paid for it, and you live by that. You love your work. You might as well. So I looked into OnlyFans, and with OnlyFans, you know this, you have to connect your bank.
Yeah, immediately, or you're not getting verified. Or
money is my middle name, and I was like, oh, no, I have to connect my bank? Oh, no. So I really looked into it, and I was like, okay, it's legitimate, whatever. So I connected my bank, boop,
and then see how fast those payouts are, I know it was the best decision you thought 100%, you ever made.
But now the payouts are a little different, what we're going to get into, because of what had just happened. But
it's funny you say that, because it's
a little weird right now,
it's
right?
It's a little weird.
Yeah, because you're like, wait, I just got this email about a new fan, but I don't see the money on it. So I'm like,
somebody outed him on the gram, like, so broke it down, so, what they did.
I don't know if I want to stray away from
Thorne?
You. Yeah, Bella Thorne, but... All
right,
so look, we'll get into shit.
Right, whatever.
So this girl, I don't know, mind you, I have no idea who Bella Thorne is.
Hold on, you want to shoot a shot first?
Yeah, let's shoot a shot to Bella. But hold on, let's make this really clear, Bella Thorne, and I'm going to clip this. Bella Thorne, I don't knock you for making a quick $3 million in 24 hours.
Period.
Fire.
That's insane.
I don't care about anyone else on the platform, including myself. If I was going to make $3 million in a day, fuck what anybody else has to think. And that's just as simple as that. So shout out to Bella Thorne for shooting a shot.
Hold on, how much?
She made $3 million in 24 hours.
$3 million.
But she didn't post no nudes. She posted one picture. She made them think she was going to. Everybody was kind of mad about it because they were like, they thought they were paying for this.
Right, right.
And then they didn't get that. So that's another thing that comes in OnlyFans
where, like, genius.
But at the same time,
you thirsty motherfuckers are trying to see
it. Right.
Yo, shout out to her. That's dope.
Shout out to her.
It's definitely dope. But she fucked it up,
right? I don't even think you needed to come back and make an apology because. What you apologizing for?
Yeah,
I don't care how much you're worth or where your worth is at. $3 million is a bag to anybody.
Did she get it all or she had to give it back?
Huh?
Did
no, she got
she
it.
She didn't have to give shit back.
She didn't have to give shit back. But Instagram, that, I mean, OnlyFans changed their policy for right. everyone else.
Right. Now you can't. Now you can't sell anything over $50.
Yeah. Now you right. can't sell anything that over $50.
So if you're sending out, can't. The thing with OnlyFans is you're not only making money off the monthly subscription. You can send out private messages.
I do it all day. Every takeover. Shout out to every lady that's ever done a takeover with me. Check me.
Definitely amazing. Like you can send out a mass message to all of your fans.
Mass message has made me over. $15,000.
And you could send a video and say, hey, babe, look at this video of me twerking in a pool and charge $7 or whatever you want.
And that's why a free account is lit.
$50 per video, you know what I mean? And then you send that video out. They have to pay that to unlock it. Right. And then you, they see
the caption,
though.
There was no limit before.
No limit before, so that's what kind of messed it up.
So if you were Kylie, you could have charged a
A ban.
A yeah,
ban,
you, right. had, you had girls right. like you had girls like right. Alex charging or Selena Powell charging $150 to see them fuck Young Thug.
Right.
And these weird
now
ass
it's $50
people.
Bucks.
I subscribed to all of them.
It's insane.
No, I'm saying, like, but now $50 is the max.
I guess I haven't.
We got to give it some time. It just that was just so yeah. happened all at once that you know they needed to accommodate. You know,
see me, I'm a numbers guy. I don't want. I like first of all, I'm a male. I'm coming in the OnlyFans game. And also, for all my followers that support me, I always try to keep everything cheap. I'm in the numbers. Like, I'll take $5 from 400 people while right. other people want to, you know.
Take 20 and 20, then you're not going to get that many right, people.
Because,
and then if you do the math.
Because once again, they don't want everybody to see it. Right. I want you to see what I got going on.
Right. right.
And I want you to right. see what's going on. Or I want you to see how this happened. I want you to see. I ain't no shame in my game.
Listen, I mean, if you're smart with money, it's supply and demand. If you're putting it at a price that's lower, you're going to have more people attracted.
And
it.
We're doing 4 takeovers a month now. That's how we killing them now. Right, right. This is the first.
And I just want to say, like, I respect that hustle so much. Even, like, absolutely. You thinking, like, as a male to right. start that. Because
to be in the top 4% male.
Yeah, that's awesome. You know what I mean?
Not
yeah.
a porn star. Now. Last right. time we were on here, you
was at
it
six.
Was higher.
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm like kind of getting into the lane of starting to manage people because, again, like I said, I have the capital. Capitalize. I have the capital to invest. You know what I mean? So why not invest in somebody who's going to blow up maybe even quicker than me? Because maybe they are being like Supreme Patty facts. Doing that viral shit.
Right.
So why not me invest into them and me get cut a check off of their shit?
That's
so
genius. That's
my
smart.
Thing is, I've been telling so many people, and that's why I love to see that he started OnlyFans. I'm like, yo, for instance, a male influencer that has a shit ton of followers that, you know, girls just want to be around for the clout. Why not make an OnlyFans and these bitches that want to be around the clout, you know, have them hop on your OnlyFans. Boom, that's a whole other lane of revenue.
Yeah. Right. So hold on. Let's just clarify that. I love that you said that because I'm just going to clarify that for my behalf. I used to not, like, do that. Like, girls that were around for the clout or just girls that were fans in general, they couldn't even get around me. But now, with
you
OnlyFans.
You see a way to make money off of it.
Now we have a mutual agreement. Right. Like, hold up. You want to come around? We're going to shoot some content. Cameras are going to be out. And if I don't know you, I'm sending you this model release.
Right, right. No, no matter what, I'm just going to tell you straight up as a model, right. you should always
do it. Oh, yeah. Well, OnlyFans is a little tricky, though, because it's weird because I should always do a model release. But sometimes it'd be the moment. Like, I don't carry them in my back
it's
pocket.
It's also because, like, you might be shooting with girls that you know are cool with you
right,
or whatever.
Right.
But when the, you know, time comes that you're at a million followers, right?
Yeah,
what happens then when they want their cut? You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah.
That's when you really all have right, to great. Think, like, now, like, okay, that's my friend, but money is money.
Yeah.
So at the end of the day, so, you know, people are going to, you know, see that check and be like, oh, I need my parts now, even though maybe 5 years ago that yeah. wasn't the case. So you always have to protect yourself with
so
that.
I got for three sure. questions, three last questions about
oh, let's shoot a shot.
Oh, let's
shoot our shot. But
damn, y'all killed me. I'm gonna be the biggest one.
I got one more thing I want to talk about, though, about OnlyFans, though. I got one thing I want to talk about real quick.
All right.
So, you know.
Okay, go.
I started my OnlyFans, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And
I want to know what you do on OnlyFans. I know because I subscribe.
You better pay that right. check, Sayna.
Shout out you because, you know, I got that subscription about 3 days ago. He's like, let me see what this is really about before I have her on the podcast.
Hey, do you want me to give a review, yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, go, but tell me what
that.
You do on OnlyFans first.
So on OnlyFans, you know, I'm a model.
Facts.
So on OnlyFans, I have a lot of people that love my model work, you know, my professional work. I have a business to run. I have so many different lanes of income. that I have to watch what I put out there because it can come back in 10 years to haunt me.
Smart.
So at the end of the day, I have to watch, you know, what you said, you know, there's girls that have 500K on Instagram and they're posting whatever because they don't care. That's the bag. I support that. 100% do you. Right. But me, I have so many distinct lanes of income that maybe this one lane of income wouldn't support this other lane of income. So I kind of have to try to keep the lanes, you know, all in one direction.
Going on the same highway.
Exactly. Facts. So with OnlyFans, it's like, you know, I post a lot of my behind the scenes work. So for instance, if I'm doing a nude shoot, I'll have my, if I don't have, you know, assistant on the shoot, normally I always have an assistant. I always bring somebody with me. And 9 times out of 10, it's a male because obviously if it's a new photographer, always bring a male with you. You know what I mean?
Right.
Bringing two girls doesn't help anything. You know what I mean? So I always normally have a male with me or whatever the case may be. If I don't have somebody with me because it's a photographer I'm close with, I'll set the phone up on my own or I'll have, again, like the assistant record behind the scenes video. So I'm doing a nude shoot. They're getting the behind the scenes of the nude shoot. They're not only getting the pictures, they're getting the behind the scenes. So majority of my work on OnlyFans are my professional pictures that are more risque, you know what I mean? Implied, nude, whatever the case may be, but it's art. It's not, and again, like I said, I don't have anything against the girls on their bed rubbing their clit. Like,
now,
shit.
Now, hold on, I got a question.
I like to watch, you know? Like,
I got a question. Have you ever done that? Have you ever played with yourself on the OnlyFans? Or
no. I mean, I got my personal videos in my camera roll.
Time out. I'm glad you said that because I'm just about to ask you.
Right.
Now, have you ever sent your personal videos to other people?
My boyfriends.
Okay. So, now, my thing I always say, if you
now, if I blow up, they can catch a bag off that shit, but I'm suing, so.
But hold on, cease and desist immediately. But,
I'm catching that bag like, that shit looks great. I don't care.
I always say, if you're willing to send it for free to somebody that you fuck with, why not fuck with your supporters and make the bag off?
That's what I always say. 100%. What you just said, I love that because, again, like I said, my lanes have to stay in one direction. But if I wasn't that girl who had so many different lanes to be able to grow in, and I saw myself as like, oh, let me just make this mill real quick off of OnlyFans. Yeah. I have so many, that mill's gonna come through
a thousand different ways. Right.
So many different ways, right? So my thing is, if you're a female and you could capitalize, make that mill off the OnlyFans, who gives a shit? You know what I mean? Like, can't. I don't judge no matter what. Like, I'm not.
They do say. I will say this, and I'm not completely for this hypothetically, but I will say it's great advice. If you could find a way to keep people subscribed to you without having to post nudes, you'll make a lot of money.
Yeah. And that goes back to the stock market shit. That goes back to the stock market.
And also just like your support too. Like, so my OnlyFans, I will tell you, I have a steady subscription of at least 75 subscribers. Mm. And those are set. If I pulled up my stats, you should know. It'll tell you each user how much they've spent on you in the total amount of time, right? So it'll say, oh, this user has been subscribed for 6 months. This user has been subscribed for 8 months, blah, 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 whatever the case may be. I don't exactly remember when I started my OnlyFans, but I have a good 75, again, at least, that subscribe each month.
What's your subscription price?
$15.99.
What is your at name on so they can follow you?
Maddie Batty. So it's MaddieBadieEE. So I changed it.
We'll put it down in the description. But usually 5,000 to 7,000 people watch this. So hopefully you'll get some subscribers.
Right. So with that though, I used to have Maddie Bidding. You know what I mean? With my last name. But again, the UMTV kind of thing influenced that. So I was like, you know, let me take my last name away from that, just because the connotation that OnlyFans has. You know what I mean?
No, that's a good name though. Right.
So I just went with that. Whatever the case may be. So I'm $15.99 a month or whatever. But
Here's the thing. Here's the deal. A lot of people have the same aspect going into it. And it doesn't come until you run into a tough time with money.
Right.
Tough time with money, you go on there and say, yo, all right, fuck it. I'm about to sell this video.
Right.
And you might be with your man.
Right.
Or some dude that you're messing with. And that's cool.
Right.
The first video is going to go crazy. So if you got 75 people, I guarantee you at least 60 out of the 75.
Right. And what I meant by that steady 75 is that 75 is from the very first time I started all the way through to today.
So are you selling videos too?
What do you mean?
So you are, is there any type of video you can sell? Not going not crazy? So listen. So I learned this recently. I didn't even know how to lock messages in a message.
Right. Like and, the mass messaging
like
thing?
The mass messaging right. And locking messages.
So and I didn't learn that either until like 4 months in. Yeah. So I started making a lot more money once I did.
I make more money off of tips on the average.
Right.
Meaning like unlocking the video.
That's because you're probably showing so much love and giving such a low price. They're like, I appreciate yes. you. That's why. Yeah.
Yes. And I'm dealing with girls that everybody know.
Right.
That's my, that.
So my they're wanting thing, a tip to be like, I fuck yo, with I, that yo, girl yo, the most.
Yo, my
name. I mean, they're tipping 20 on the bitch with the fattest lie. Ass on his face.
I can't even lie. Yep. Here's my whole formula. I'm going to give it up. I don't care what anybody.
Blueprints. You better listen right now because these Johns aren't normally free.
Let's go.
I say, I go to a girl. If I think she's like a bartender that's pretty popular, or I mainly look for bartenders. If you don't know who I am, mostly everybody knows who I am in Bucks County, but I try to gravitate towards
And again,
Bucks County.
I just want
to
say I appreciate the hustle so much. Like
absolutely. Absolutely. But I'm just going to give it this. So when you're making $5,000 a month, I don't care about that money. That money, I never thought I was going to make that to begin with.
Right.
Okay. So now I'm like, okay. If I go to a bartender and be like, yo, I got $500 for you to get on hop of my OnlyFans.
Right.
Today. Like, not tomorrow. Matter of fact, I'll give you $250
now.
I'll
give
it to you now. Right now.
Yeah. I'll give you
now.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'll call me
I'll
later.
I'll give you the other $250 after we're done.
After we're done.
Right.
Boom. Now they're like, now they don't know how, like, they're shocked that I'm
They just want that $500 right there.
They want the $500. And if you got OnlyFans and you got a couple followers, you got to open checkbook.
Yo, like one question though for you. Do you got any referrals?
I was going to get into that.
Oh, that's great.
Oh my God.
Oh, it's another great one.
Yo, I'm going to even shout this girl. Two girls out. Amber and Lori. Amber and Lori actually in Rachel. Rachel don't really do her OnlyFans, but Amber and Lori, I'm the one that convinced them to do OnlyFans.
Right.
These girls probably have
hopped
like,
in your bag.
Like these girls literally have like probably like 50 and 150 between both of them. Like one girl has 150, one girl has 50. If I were to use my referral code, and mind you, they're charging outrageous numbers.
Right.
Like 25,
right.
$18.99, right. Weird ass numbers. They're charging that. Right. Okay. And I'm like, damn. I need that 10% for right. both of all this money.
And that 99 cents is a marketing tool. You know what I mean? If you see that $16 sure. versus that $15.99, it's a penny difference, but they're going
to
be like... Because
they take 20%.
That $9.99.
Yeah, so I always thought to change my shit to $12 instead of $10.
So that I could you're get getting 10 that 10. Yeah.
On the dot, but I'll take the 8.
Right.
I'm cool with that. Yeah. But like I said, it's not but about that for
as time grows, you're going to... Like, I started no, on OnlyFans with as $10.99. Time grows,
I'm about to make it free.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Because you know why
I'm going to make it... you're going to make it free, and then you're going to charge per post.
Because here's... Yeah, I'm going to
Well, that's how you make more... We were just talking about
well,
that.
Well, here's the thing about OnlyFans, and I'm glad we're having this conversation, because I can really relate to you on this. Like I said, Jimmy Smacks, he's the best... OnlyFanser on OnlyFans. I can't shout this guy out enough. Jimmy Smacks is the best OnlyFanser on OnlyFans. Like he does OnlyFans like we do Snapchat.
Right.
Okay. With that being said,
that's eventually what I want to get into too. Like tea time. You know how I be doing tea time.
He does all that. So hear me out. So his OnlyFans looks like Instagram.
Right.
So he'll have a like for example, he's with Danny Banks in Las Vegas right now. I'm jealous. I hit him up all the time. I'd be like, yo, I tip him $50, $100. Like, I'd be like, yo, just listen. First time, I was like, yo, here's $150. Just listen to what I got to say. Yo, right. I'm Checkmate TV. I'm popping. I fuck with you. We need the link.
And that's
he's like, yo,
thing. Yeah,
anytime
like
you come to Miami, holla at me. I said, bet. I'll be
in Miami.
I'm
already in Miami. You heard. I'm already in Miami. Hit me up.
I'll send him this clip. All
right.
All right. Anyway. So anyway, Jimmy Smacks is lit. He has 152,000 followers, something crazy. And he made over like $7 million in like the last, from January to now. So with that being said, I'm like, damn, like, you know, I'm watching this shit and like, you know, and I think the free account is the way to go.
I think we should take a shot to him.
We really should. Oh. And I found him through my favorite girl in the world, Selena Powell. Shout out to Selena Powell. She's ratchet as fuck.
So Selena Powell's the same girl who just said that shit about Odell, right?
Yeah!
Right.
No, no, No. She interviewed the girl who said that about Odell. Okay. And I've been, hold on. I got to shout.
Did you see her story, though?
I got to shout myself out on this podcast. I talked about everything before it happens. I said a month ago, Selena Powell is my favorite girl on Instagram and my favorite girl on OnlyFans. Next thing you know, she gets a deal with Adam22.
No joke.
Shout out to Adam22. And now she's over there viral every fucking weekend.
Y'all going to be at his level soon. Just wait on it.
Wait on it. And this is a comparison that I'm going to get into. I think you're on a Yes Jules lane.
Right.
I'm not as sure if you know who Yes Jules is. Right. You know who Yes Jules is.
Yeah, definitely. And that's the crazy part. I always tell people, I'm like, yo, you know who Yes Jules is? Well, when it comes to
Out to Yes Jules. Right. Because I love her hustle. I love everything she's done.
Right.
You know, I met her once or twice, and, you know, we've, like, every time I talk to her, she's so genuine, she's so humble, and also, like, just the vibe of being a woman. I don't care about no blogs, I don't care about no dirt, I don't care about nothing.
Shit.
I don't care about no controversy. Like, that woman literally went to Miami or went to L.A., they came back to Miami and threw all these parties and made millions of dollars off of that.
Love that, love that. So,
and I still follow her. She's in Rolls Royces every day. On her own, no guys in the picture.
And I love that.
That's
we're gonna
empowering.
Get into that woman empowerment shit, because that's definitely something I really want to talk about. But
and I'm not even a woman. I'm like, damn, Yes Jules is killing it.
Right.
I don't care if it's rented, bought. Yo, her condo. So Jimmy Smacks lives.
What is she doing to get the bag?
Hold on, we're gonna get into that. Let's shoot a shot.
All right, let's shoot a shot.
Let's get it. So, y'all got me. Woo.
Yeah.
Shout out
to you for pouring out the shot.
Yo, y'all give me the biggest shot every time. I love it, though.
Yo. Come on, check.
I am checkmate, check dollar, check beat.
My shit right there with you.
All right. So, Yes Jules. So, I don't want to act like I know everything about her, because I don't. But, from the outside looking in, this is how I see it. Yes Jules is from Miami. Started her thing called 1AM Vibes. 1AM Vibes was a party promotion company.
Right.
Well, she started throwing parties on her own without the company. And this is something, segue real quick. Maddie Bitting is so marketable. That name sounds like something I've heard before. Shout out to your parents. Shout out to your parents for naming you that, because what's your whole name?
Madison Elizabeth Bitting.
All right, so
Queen Elizabeth, because I'm a queen. You feel me?
Madison Bitting even sounds good. Or Madeline Bitting. That sounds like something I've heard before.
Right.
That's marketable. Right. Yo, I was thinking of this, like, because I'm a marketing guy. Like I said, I think about it from the gate. Maddie Bitting.
I'm trying to brand Maddie B.
I don't know why. It just sounds like a sewing company I've heard before. Like fucking something I've made before. It sounds like all types of shit that I've heard before.
Right.
Like, I'm like, okay.
It's a bold name. I'm a bold bitch. Name.
Shout out to you for being that.
Right.
And, you know, whatever the situation is. So back to Yes Jules and the path that I think
I'm headed towards a little bit.
Okay, so once again, Yes Jules at first was throwing her parties on her own.
Right.
Okay, she was throwing her parties, 1 a.m. vibes. After South by Southwest in Miami, she would have her after party. I was following her back in 2014, 2015, when the venues wasn't letting her in, and she would call venues on the spot. It would be 8 o'clock, and she's calling venues like, I got 400 people with me right now. Like, I need half the door when you come here. I'm going to pack your venue up.
Bullshit! Hustle. Yo, I love this.
This is a fact. I've been following her since the beginning.
Right.
And, you know, as far as that, then she got her company branded, 1 a.m. Vibes.
Right.
You know, then she started throwing parties. Then she got friends with, like, some big rappers. Right. Like, you know, 2017, 2018, she was real good friends with XXX and Trippy.
Shout out to South Florida. It's popping.
Yo, XXX was really backing her.
I'm actually in South Miami, so.
I remember when she was going through some shit and fucking XXX gave her his security and fucking all this other crazy shit. Like, I've been following her and Aggie Abby for a long time. And especially, I would say Yes Jules for you, because it's just like, like, you're in Miami, you know what I'm saying? You're of Caucasian descent, for lack of better words, you know. Right. I don't know, you know, that she's in a hip hop urban community.
Right.
I don't know if you're targeting rappers or if you're targeting, like, you know, that for your parties or whatever the situation may be. Or I don't know if you're just doing it all for your fan base, but what she was doing, it was like you said, what you're doing.
Bringing in big people.
She was bringing in like a XXX that
like
would
a
perform.
Headliner.
A XXX that's when he's on top of the world that would perform for free, basically. And she could take the whole door of 1,000 people times 50. So she's making 50
50K,
grand.
50K off one event.
One event, a Saturday night, she's coming back and collecting 50K.
Well, I'm sure he was getting a piece.
Well, yeah, 100%, but he was showing love, though. That was his friend. That was her friend.
Well, that goes into the drama.
Right. I don't really know too much about that.
Yeah, they have to look that shit up. We here for her. So
well, we're here for you. But at the end of the day, like I said, at the end of the day, I see you going along that path.
Right.
Facts.
You know, first thing I can recommend is get your feet wet in the party realm. And I have a lot of connects. So if you ever need something, you know. You know, whoever you need, I get them for the low. A favor for a favor is always granted in my book. Because I did a lot of
things.
I always
cut checks too. Like, I mean, if somebody's helping out, like
I am checked.
Money, right. Money rings people's ears. So I mean, if you're offering a
and
check,
if you got
I
the
mean,
capital, like
exactly.
So her thing was getting underground artists before they really popped,
right,
and making a party off it,
right.
Shit, underground artists be happy for that $2,500.
And I'm sure, they're in South Florida.
She was targeting an audience that was maybe less capital to put up front.
Like, for example, I give you a prime example. Like, let's just say 42 Doug, the first record, the first week that Lil Baby record comes out.
Right.
You say, oh, Lil 42 Doug, I want you tonight.
Right.
He like, how much? I want 4,000.
4,000, yeah.
Boom. All right, bam, I got that for you.
Right.
He got a hit record.
Although we're gonna just say this, they're getting $2,000 up front and then $2,000 when they show up, and there's a contract,
and there's a contract involved.
If you know what you're doing, there's a contract involved. You don't give no money out until they sign that paper. You know what I mean?
Smart.
And even getting it notarized. We're not even talking business.
We're just talking straight up. Hypothetical.
Right. No, I like that though.
Right.
Yeah, because I don't know 42 Doug's price, so I don't.
You
can
get burnt.
I'm just letting you know because you know this is shoot your shot, so I want other people to know. When
what she say?
This shoot your shot.
Pour it up.
So basically, like, you know what I mean? Like, I want to let people know.
So for the girls for the people that want to throw parties in general. It's real easy to get in contact with people. And that's one thing I love Selena Powell for. I give her credit. And this is a podcast where I'm gonna give a lot of women credit because we have a woman guest. Selena Powell.
Woman empowerment.
Woman empowerment.
Yeah, we can talk about that.
I've literally been talking about
Selena. I definitely want to talk about that.
Hold on. So I hope Selena sees this.
And I want to say one more thing about Yes Jules before we're done. But go ahead.
Well, we're going to come right back to her. Don't worry, because that's one of my favorite girls. But
well, matter of fact, look, let you say that, and let's shoot a shot.
But hold on.
Now we'll.
I might hold off on this one for a little bit.
That's cool.
All right.
All right, let me talk really quick.
So is it
going to
be me and Jumbo? All right, go talk then. We're not going to shoot a shot.
All right. No. Y'all shoot the shot. I'm going to start.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Let's take a sip.
Yeah, because it's just for the optic.
Right,
let's go.
I'll take a little of
it. I don't care what you do. Nobody can see what's in your cup.
Literally a little sip.
You don't gotta give them all the details.
It's all right. I'm transparent. Remember that?
Absolutely.
So I like letting people know.
Well,
I'll
let you know they give me the biggest one and that shit go down. I got a little bit left because I'm on my Maddie bidding time.
So.
And I got to drive.
Right.
Yeah.
Right to the next spot. You already know we lit tonight. You already know movie tonight. Watch the
viral
snaps.
Movie. I'm in this bitch with the woos. But right. So
what'd you want to say about Yes Jules?
With Yes Jules, I actually ask a lot of people, like, yo, you with the event planning mainly, like that's one of the lanes of revenue that I bring her up in.
Absolutely.
I'm like, yo, you know who Yes Jules is?
Yeah,
she's the people, you know what I mean?
She's the number one event planner in my eyes.
So I always say, yo, you know
other
who
than
Yes
the
Jules
corporation.
Is? Right. And they're like, yeah or no, whatever the case may be. I'm like, yo, she's somebody who has a personality, you know what I mean? Broadcasted that personality. and then went ahead and capitalized off of being able to bring people together and have a good time. And yeah, again, absolutely. Like I said, that's what the name was about. Like, you know what I mean?
1 a.m. vibes, that was literally the whole sum of Yes Jules.
Right. So, absolutely. Like, I definitely love what she did with that. Like, I definitely, you know, shout out her, obviously.
All right. So, hold on. I got to ask this because, you know, we're deep into the podcast. I'm a few shots in and now. I'm asking this.
I like the juicy shit. So.
So we're getting juicy now. It's time to get juicy. It's time to get down to the oils. Now, a lot of people say, yes, Jules only was able to throw those parties because she got fake implants.
Okay.
And her ass is super fat and she got big titties.
Well, now that's the whole world.
Hold on.
Does she have ass implants?
No, she has Brazilian butt lift, supposedly. I don't know if that's true. This is just an observation. That's what everybody says.
I thought her butt was real and I was just like, oh.
I thought it was real too because I love her. So I thought everything on her was real. I thought she was just a stallion, for lack of better words.
What was her parents feeding her? Because I need a plate.
Yeah, no bullshit.
But hold on.
Do you think you need to get plastic surgery to captivate the audience?
Wow. I love that question. So, not at all. I feel like...
Hold on. Will you ever get plastic surgery?
I can't really answer that right now because I feel
Yeah, because you're super young.
Yeah.
And I just also feel like, that. You know, stuff might change. Like, I could use a little bit in the lips, you know what I mean?
Shout out to the lip injections. I got a couple doctors for you.
Right. I mean, shit, if it's free,
it might be for the low if you say Checkmate TV.
Nah, but like, if you want me to be all honest. Oh, okay, Dr. Johnson. I might have to look into you. But nah.
Anyway.
If we really want to look into that, I don't see myself getting surgery at all because I was born this way and I want to, you know, again, that's me.
Shout out Lady Gaga.
Yeah, but hold on. Shout out Miley Cyrus. But,
Miley Cyrus.
Yo, I just watched her on Joe Rogan. I love her.
Wait, can I just say something? From a young ass age, love Miley. You want to know why?
Shout out to Miley Cyrus.
No, that's my favorite bitch ever, and anybody who knows me will be able to tell you that. That bitch went through so much criticism because she was a Disney star, right? So she had to live up to something. Exactly. So she had a brand to, you know, enforce. She had a brand
Shout
to live
out
by.
To Miley Cyrus. I love her.
100%.
Yo,
I low key
would have fucked Miley Cyrus.
Oh, I would fuck her.
Miley, I would wife you. Holla at your boy, Checkmate TV.
Check underscore mate underscore TV.
Shoot your shot podcast. Right. We here. Miley Cyrus, I'm coming to the ranch. You said you got 50 acres with you and your dad and all that. I'm coming.
Right.
And I'm going to tell you, I'm not like them turtles that's just feeding your feet and all that weird shit. I'm going to keep it a buck and a quarter with you, and we going vibe.
So Miley Cyrus is
Miley Cyrus is
one of my favorite people on
shout
the
shout out to you for loving Miley. Yo, I need another shot for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, no,
pour it up, check.
For Miley Cyrus.
Y'all got that because I'm definitely lit.
We need another shot. Yo, the bottle's almost had.
When it's almost gone, I'm gonna take my shot.
Yo, when the bottle's gone, we gone.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Facts.
Miley Cyrus, let me say something. Miley Cyrus.
It's amazing.
I love that bitch.
Great voice.
Talented as fuck.
The black community and I'm always pro-black. I just...
Did you pop that already?
Hold on. And I went against the... Time out. I gotta say this. I need quiet for this clip.
Hold on. Let me just tell you. He's half-filled because you know he's feeling
I'm half-filled. I filled my shit up.
You're full-filled, though. Like, you're fulfilled.
But that's neither here nor there.
That's cool.
Miley Cyrus, listen. I went against this Donald Trump nonsense with our biggest artist so far. And I'm all for the African-American community.
Right.
With that being said, I feel like Miley Cyrus made twerking popular. In 2012, when Miley Cyrus went on the VMAs or whatever award show that was and twerked, that was the first time I've ever seen twerking, and I don't care what any African girl is going to tell me.
Miley is herself.
I love you. I love all my Africans, the motherland. I love you guys. Sorry, I'm not selling out. But at the end of the day,
when somebody like her does it, brings it to a different audience.
Yeah, right. But, she had so much, such a high audience. And yeah, the thing with her is
it's like a big thing where like they're right. saying, oh, here's cultural appropriation again. And I got to tell y'all this because I'm coming from a different vibe. And this is what I would like y'all to understand and listen. So I understand, you know, a different type of vibe. And I hate to say this, but I'm only being honest and transparent as the person I am. And this is our platform, and I'm on here, so I can only speak what I feel.
Right.
And when it gets to Donald Trump, fuck Donald Trump. But at the end of the day, when it comes to this, Miley Cyrus, even after Miley Cyrus did that twerking shit, and Jay-Z did, what it was, I don't know what album that was. I want to say Magna Carta, Holy Grail.
Yeah.
He said, twerk, Miley, Miley, twerk, Miley, Miley, twerk.
Yeah.
He didn't, like, this was the first time. This is in 2012, 2013. I don't know how old people were. I know I was grown as fuck. I was listening to this. I waited with T-Rees and watched this. I listened to all these songs, like, at 12 o'clock when they dropped on the dot. Jay-Z said, yo, twerk, Miley, Miley. I'm like, yo, Miley created it. Right. I knew that at 2012.
Listen, it's the difference between creating it and making it popular. So,
that's true. Oh, well, let me rephrase my words. Molly made it popular. Right. Because Africans cool. been twerking for a
Listen,
long time.
Mike Will did a beat with Miley.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
No, but so, Miley is amazing. Somebody, the reason why I love Miley so much is because she had to deal with a contract. She had to deal with Disney, you know what I mean? And then after she got out of that, you know, she wanted people to know who she was.
Yeah. We're going to get Miley. I'm going to speak this into existence. We are going to get Miley on the Shoot Your Shot podcast.
And I'm coming here.
And you will be here. Maddie-bitting Miley Cyrus.
Because that is my bitch.
Yeah, we'll make it happen.
We're going to make it happen.
She's just herself.
She
That's
just did
why
that Joe Rogan podcast. I watched the whole 2 hours.
I watched all her interviews.
I almost turned on the RuPaul Paul situation because she was vouching for it so hard.
Listen, that was the first Spotify John that when he signed his deal.
Shout
shit.
Out to Miley so, Cyrus.
She's just really herself, and that's what I believe in. Like, she really supports herself.
She definitely does.
She's
I
confident.
Like that.
She.
Oh,
again,
give a Miley Cyrus
thing.
Drop
remember,
right here. Right here. Same. Tell me everything you love about Miley Cyrus right here.
Wait, remember when you said, oh, you need plastic surgery? Look at Miley. Miley is don't a badass bitch and doesn't give a fuck. She don't got no fat ass, but she treats her ass like it's fat, and that's what it's about. You know
Absolutely.
What I mean?
Absolutely.
Like, you need to support what you're...
Love Miley
she
Cyrus.
Can't, she can't get attacked by nobody because she's so bold in who she is. And that's what I believe in. Like, you know, she really believes in who she is. And she
has a great perspective of life.
100%. You know, she's
Joe
so
Rogan,
open-minded.
Yeah, that Joe
and
Rogan.
That's so important.
I think that might be the ayahuasca and the DMT, but we're not going to talk about that.
Right.
Shout out to Miley Cyrus.
Shout out to Miley Cyrus. Let's
Miley
shoot a shot,
Cyrus.
Chad. Let's shoot our shot.
We're all shooting a shot. Maddie is shooting her shot, too. We're all here. All this right. is, you know, we're rocking and rolling. We're not going to shoot
hey,
a shot to Miley Cyrus.
Hey, check. Should we do this quick hits real quick?
Yeah.
What's quick hits?
Well, hold on. I'm going to come right back to that.
Uh-oh.
Actually, Uh-oh. Yeah, go shoot your... Yeah, let's go. Just do the quick hits.
Listen, I got some questions for you.
Okay.
I just need you to... You know what I mean?
Right.
Whatever comes to the
first
head.
First answer on your mind. If there's an answer... If there's something I want to expound on,
I talk a lot, so it's hard for me to answer, like,
we see,
quick.
We're at an hour and, like, a half already.
Yeah. But, you know,
you're about to be the longest
gonna...
podcast yet.
Motherfuckers is going
to
watch
Shout out to Maddie Bidding for giving us the
for
longest
sure.
podcast yet.
We got so much tea to talk about. That's the thing. Like,
we didn't even get started yet. I got, like, 7 more on my sheet.
Well,
I
we'll know. Make those quicker than everything else, though. We'll do this.
Yeah,
I think this would be cool for right now. Yeah, we on, like, small.
No, 100%.
I got a few things I'm going to touch on.
Yeah. I love
hey,
the
yo, if you get if you got
and
a quick hit.
And even if it's longer than normal, it's like, this
it
is
It don't
my
matter. I'm not worried about it.
Right,
it's longer than normal.
This is
Fuck
my
it.
Opportunity to really talk about everything
and
I
want
to.
You to.
And I have too many lanes, so that's maybe why it's longer, because I got more lanes than the average.
And,
you feel me?
And like, they're going to watch it.
Well,
right,
we're not gonna discuss any other artist or person that's been on Shoot Your Show
oh,
podcast.
And I'm not saying that any other
but
way.
But at the end of the day, you do have a lot of shit going
but
on.
But to keep Period. It real, we just started getting people on Shoot Your Shot.
Right.
So.
Absolutely. It was
and
me
listen,
and Jumbo
listen.
At first. We built this up from the mud.
For
I'm sure.
gonna
me
y'all,
and Jumbo.
I'm gonna bring y'all so many people that are interested in this podcast that it's not
love
even
it.
Funny. You
I
already know.
I believe it.
No,
love
so
it.
Many people are gonna wanna hop on this joint
and
after.
And you know how many people
I'm
gonna bring you?
100%. This is a team. Now that I've worked with them, you already know, like, this is a team effort. Like, all about, again, the Philly love, you know, idea from, you know, my content
PSPs, shoot. PSPs, Philly support Philly.
Let me
exactly.
just say, though, you can only get on here if you got something going on.
If you got something going on.
If you're shooting your shot.
Right.
If you're shooting your shot.
Yo, right. Pour let him know.
Pour it up. She said it. Pour it up.
Let him know.
Why'd I do it? I'm starting to feel like this seat don't even exist anymore.
So the seat is not existing. I feel like I'm kneeling.
It's like,
what is the seat below us?
I don't even feel it anymore. I feel like I'm floating.
Oh, why are you skipping me?
Oh, I'm getting there.
Listen, I didn't know if Maddie wanted one, so I slid it into
Maddie's
the vicinity.
Maddie's going to take one. She's a gangster on the low.
I slid
it
into the...
I'm trying to tell you, she's a gangster on the low. You know what I mean? And with some OGs behind her, she's been dealing with a lot of young bulls. Now she got some OGs behind her, including myself.
Period.
So now she's going
to
Shout
out to Maddie. She came up here...
Oh! We almost killed...
You know what a bomb does? We almost done.
Y'all know I don't feel the seat at this point.
Like, what seat?
And I don't even be drinking motherfucking Henny. Like,
all right.
Damn.
Well, I know listen. My phone's blowing up. You know I got that flash and shit.
Yeah, yeah. You got the bougie ringtone. I hate when people...
Let me just text.
No, we're not texting nobody on the Shoot Your Shot podcast.
Well, listen.
Fuck him.
Let's shoot a
fuck
shot.
Fuck her. Whoever it is.
Right.
Yo.
They can wait.
I'm not even going to say the name I seen.
Yeah, don't.
Shoot him.
His head is going to blow up. Like,
no, we're not blowing nobody up. So let's get it.
Shoot your shot.
Shoot your shot, dickheads.
Dickhead. Woo! I don't even think I can take this, John. Honestly, I'm on the way, actually. All right,
bet.
It feels
well,
cool.
Look, we're going to be able to do this quick hit.
Hey,
right?
Yo, I just spilled fucking a shot on my shirt.
He
listen,
got the
that
white...
happened to me the first shot, so I don't feel bad.
You know what you say? You know what they say? That white tea.
You can buy white another tea. One. It's all right.
All right. It's cool. Before we go out tonight, guess where I'll be? Buying another white tea.
Right in the corner store with the white
tea.
Right.
Absolutely.
We hitting that after hours tonight, yo. You already know.
All right, so look.
Movie.
Damn,
so look,
don't
ready?
Mind this, though. I feel weird. I never spilled a shot
it's
on
it's all right, check. I do it like every shot. It's
oh,
all good.
This is like, I feel like a lot of firsts for the podcast.
Yeah. We got a girl on. I'm getting all panicking. I got fucking shit on my shirt. What the fuck is going
yo,
on?
Yo, let me just say, I feel empowered that I'm the first female.
Well, that's what you should feel.
Nah, I definitely appreciate y'all, but I'm ready for this
you
quick
ready?
Question. I'm interested.
All right, let's do the quick hits, Jumbo.
Let's
cue up the quick hits.
Well, I gotta be quick and I'm long.
Now, you don't
have
to be, you don't have to be quick.
Same.
Because checkmate
I'm
even
supposed
add
to be
on.
Quick and I'm long.
Ooh.
Oh, checkmate
bars.
Said, hold on. Checkmate anyway. Said retweet.
Retweet bars. Retweet. Go ahead.
What? The fuck?
All right. Yo, don't make
shout
me.
Shout out to OnlyFans / Checkmate TV.
Don't make me laugh too hard. I might have to take a break to go to the bathroom. Go ahead.
Now I got
to
rearrange my list.
No,
what the fuck?
No, keep it going.
Hit it. Jumbo, let's get it. I'm ready.
Keep
I'm ready.
Keep it going.
All right, well, look. We keep it real for the artists.
100%.
We got a lot of
facts.
People watching this.
The real is me.
Yo,
I'm
don't be shy this girl, bro.
Oh, 100%.
Go. Listen, also another thing.
Fuck
being a girl,
her, let's go.
Fuck being a girl. Let's just say, I don't matter if you got a pussy or a penis. I'm dominant as shit. I carry it like I'm a man. I don't care. Hit
they
me.
Said you would
hit,
say that.
Hit me with it. Hit me with it.
It's not even that
hold
deep.
Hold on. I gotta roll my eyes on that one.
He said it's not even that
deep.
No,
it's that deep for me.
All right. Let's hear. I was kind of scared about these questions. Now I'm not really.
Nah,
let's
go. I was just going to say your favorite artist in Philly or the surrounding area.
Ooh, that's kind of hard, though.
Yeah.
Favorite artist. Let's
so
go.
So hard.
Five.
So let them know.
Four.
Who you fuck with.
Three.
Jazz. The Kid Jazz. Let me
Jazz,
just put him
shout
out
Shout out
here.
Jazz.
Shout out Jazz. You
who's
know who Jazz is. The Kid Jazz.
The kid jazz.
You know jazz?
Yes.
Okay,
of
I
course.
Don't.
Shout out
so,
Jazz.
So I'm just shouting him out because he's a homie. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shout out to Jazz.
I like that. I love
was,
it.
He was,
I love
you know,
it.
Building his own music. Meanwhile, he was also, you know, had his own studio. So he was bringing.
Are you
in-
talking about smooth jazz? Benjamin Jazz?
No,
no.
White Boy Jazz. Here's another thing also with, you know, rapping.
The Chamonix hit.
Rapping and shit, and you know this too. Being
I know
a,
Jazz.
Being a white boy rapping isn't the easiest thing, right? So that's why I think I have a lot more respect for him because he's hopping in the game like,
nah, shout out Jazz. He does his thing.
Shout out to Jazz.
He definitely has, pushes
you got my back
for
and
sure.
She backed you, so we all back.
And you know what I mean? Like, that's one of my brothers, so, like, I already know in the long run, if he blows up, he got me. You know what I mean? If I blow up, I got him.
Dope.
So, the
next
thing
question,
is...
Jump.
Hold on, that's your network.
That's my network, and at the end of the day, I just want to say a lot of people, you know, because he's a white boy doing this stuff, you know what I mean? He doesn't have the full support of it, you know what I mean? But he could spit. Like, he could definitely spit. And that's somebody I'm going to rock with and I'm going to support. So definitely wanted to shout him out for the local artist. But go ahead, let's go. Next question.
Next question, John. All
right, next question. Nicki or Cardi?
Ooh, definitely a diehard Nicki fan, right? But I am one of those people that I'm not going to necessarily pick a lane because I'm so versatile. That's another thing that I'm just versatile. So I can't sit here and say, oh, Nicki or Cardi. Like, I love them
next
for two
question,
different...
John.
Two different reasons. He said, next question, because I feel like you feel the same, right? You can't pick. You can't pick. Period.
Okay. I love Nicki, but Cardi's the hottest in the game.
Listen,
right now.
I would have said a name.
Nicki's 10 times better artist. But
Nicki is better, but Cardi is the hottest. So I look at it like Nicki is Jay-Z, but Cardi is Lil Wayne.
Cardi
in
got
08.
The personality.
Cardi is Lil Wayne in 08. When everybody thought Lil Wayne was going to pass Jay-Z in 08, I can't pick.
They're amazing in different ways.
Next question, John.
Sorry, I couldn't really give you an answer for that.
If you could recommend one strategy to level up your brand or your following, what would you say?
Be more personalized. For me, I have a lot of, very avid supporters, you know what I mean? Because I am so personalized. I let them in that personal level of my life that they feel more connected. They know what's going on. I wake up and I'm right on Snapchat like, yo, guys, just woke up, you know
same.
What I mean?
No haircut,
I'm late for
no
class.
I come out like, yo, fuck
raw.
It. I just come out
I
raw.
Take my Snapchat videos
I
on the toilet.
I got crust on my lips and my snaps.
Period.
I don't care. I'm not trying to bag no bitches. I'm trying to bag a million.
You know how I am on Snapchat. I hop right on there in the morning, no makeup, no whatever, right on the toilet with it.
From the gum bus.
Like, yo, this is what I got going on today, period. Like,
I don't care.
Just transparent, be you.
Content.
Right.
Content.
100%. Not even just like what you want people to see, just
next
like
question,
everything.
Jim.
Bet. All right, so I know you model.
Right.
So great photographer or great landscape?
That's a good one.
You can have a great landscape, and if the photographer doesn't know how to capture it, then the whole landscape just went to waste.
I'm going to say great photographer.
So 100% great photographer.
Yeah, because photography, I'm a photographer.
Don't matter about the landscape. You know what I mean?
It don't
you can
matter.
Have a photographer that you have a shitty landscape
absolutely.
And you turn it into something amazing.
And you could be on a great landscape and the photographer don't
sucks.
Get the right angle.
Period.
Bet.
Period.
Say that. All right, so with that being said, nude photo or clothed?
Jumbo did his research.
Here, hold up. Wait, you're checkmate TV, right? So you're yes. about that check, right?
Yes.
So I mean, I get paid more. I get paid more for showing
nude.
More skin, right?
Yes.
So I'm gonna have, and also personally, I love nude photos. I love seeing art. You know
same.
What I mean? It's not no.
You can go on checkmatetv.com. I mean, onlyfans.com/checkmatetv and.
Right, so like my
see
thing
myself.
Is I love
however
seeing,
you
want to
see it.
I love seeing a naked bitch making it classy.
Absolutely.
Making
whoa,
it.
Whoa, that was dope.
Like
a
naked
bitch
making
it
classy. So I love seeing
a
that.
A naked
so,
bitch
period.
Making it classy.
I love seeing that. It's art. At the end of the day, our bodies are art.
That
you know
sounded
I mean?
Like
a
rat
crazy creation.
On the low.
Like, period.
A naked bitch making it classy.
I kind of want to make a second bar to it real quick, but I got too much Henny in me to mess it up. Go ahead.
Yo, the Henny is gone. Y'all see this? We killed it with Maddie Bitting, too.
Period. And I think I kept up. That's just period.
You were
right.
Scared to
definitely.
Death at first.
I was,
because
I was like, Henny. But all right, let's hear the next question.
So with that being said, what's the best advice you can give to an aspiring model?
Best advice I can give to an aspiring model is definitely, show love. That goes so far. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Supporting other people in the lane that you're in will show people like, wow, this person isn't just here for this and here for that. They want to show love. They have a love for the art. You know what I mean? Other than the fact
that. Like, for example, I got you.
Right.
I've made my whole brand off of girls that showed me love.
Right.
Lexus, Texas has 15, 20 million followers.
Right.
One of the biggest porn stars in the game. She showed me love from the gun bus.
And the crazy part about it is somebody with 15 million followers, it's like you really don't think they're the type to show love because they have already.
Well, I mean, we had a relationship. Humble. We had a great relationship. But look at it.
Let me just piggyback on that. The people in them positions are the most humble.
Humble. Like,
Hell Rail, the most humble.
Humble. Yo, Hell Real came on this podcast.
It depends on what they stand by, though. At the same time, there's for also sure. people a lot of followers, and they think they're the shit because they have a lot of followers.
But they might not be successful.
They might not be successful. Lexus Texas is very successful. Right. Lexus Texas will make more money than most female.
It's different.
Hold on, I gotta put this out there. Alexis Texas makes more money than most people that will ever be on this podcast. And Alexis Texas will repost this podcast.
Right.
That's the type.
Right, and that's love.
Because she shows love, and that's what I'm all about.
And she got her own pocket.
And when Hell Rel left here, he reposted the photo instantly.
And Hell Rel, when he left here, he reposted it instantly.
Instantly.
I didn't. We didn't even ask him.
We didn't even ask him.
He asked me to send a picture.
It doesn't cost,
you feel me?
1 cent to show love.
And now, mind you, I showed Alexis Texas a lot of love.
And y'all showed love by bringing me on here. You know what I mean? Like, that's what that's all about now.
The last question I got is, any questions you want to ask me? So if you want to ask me about Alexis Texas at the end,
right?
Please do.
Okay.
I'll give you a whole rundown.
I got like one or two more.
But I got, you got one or two more?
Let's knock them two out.
And I got and three more, and then we're over.
All right, say no more.
Bet. So I know you do your party shit and all that. So a decent club or a dope-ass house party?
I would say a dope-ass house party because... it allows you to have more creative things behind it. Facts. You know what I mean? Like, you can come up with your own theme. You can
especially if it's an Airbnb that's worth a lot of money.
And if you're
been to LA a million times, and all LA is house parties.
Right. And if you're capitalizing and you know what you're doing, you know what I mean? You're hiring a security team. You're hiring all these things to make sure the house party is treated as if it was a club. You know what I mean? At the standards of a club.
But at the same time, it's always good to have the clubs to back you.
100%, but here's the thing. Clubs are getting a percentage. Guess what? You're collecting 100% of the profits at the door.
Yeah, you might collect 100%
of the profits. You're putting maybe $2,000 down on that mansion, but what are you making at the door? Yeah. Meanwhile, you know, you have to pay for the club, blah, 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 blah. You know, some people might have trouble, whatever. This is your party. You're just, like, in control more. So I feel like the house party, definitely. Dope. But I definitely love clubs. Like, y'all know I love clubs, so.
Say that.
Period. So
cool. All right. So, Fashion Nova or designer?
I love me some Louis.
Fashion Nova.
Okay.
Only reason I say Fashion Nova is I buy designer every day.
Maddie. Check.
Hold on.
Come on, dog. Like,
come on, dog. Like.
Sorry. My bad.
Because only reason I said that is because I know
the Henny hit him. He's like,
I'm on Henny now. It's my podcast. It's about to turn all the way up.
So listen, Fashion Nova got a little bougie. You know what I mean? They got that China product, but they got them designer prices. Like, not designer prices, but their demand went up, so their price went up. And that's period. And like, that's what anybody should do. So that was smart. They're rolling in the money for it, and I respect it 100%. But at the end of the day, like, another thing with designer, you see a lot of broke boys spend their whole check on designer.
No, they spend their whole check on designer.
Hold on, ready?
They go see Feast in them.
Let's get for
the
Bathing
Ape Yeezy collection that I got on my feet now.
Hold up.
They spend their whole check on the Yeezy Bathing Ape collection boot. I got a fucking I got a torn Achilles, check. And I'm wearing a high top boots that didn't even come out yet.
Check.
And they're dicked because I had them for 6 months.
Wait, check me.
That's how I'm coming.
Hold up, they're spending their whole PUA check on motherfucking designer.
Oh my god, I don't even want to get in the PUA.
When I'm saving that PUA for free rent in Miami, and they're over here in Louis just throwing a bag out. And then fake flexing on the gram. You know what I mean? So that designer shit, it's hard for me to get into that. I got the capital to support my designer. Any designer I bought, guess what? You paid for it. Period. And
yo,
that's
I got
all
a BB Simon belt on. I got the Bathing Ape collection on. I got 7 jeans on.
Listen, I flew from Miami, so I didn't want to bring too much designer shit coming back to Philly. Like, yo, what if somebody trying to try me?
But hold on. This is designer enough. This is your design.
100%.
Yo, I didn't come here with the Checkmate TV logo on because I didn't want to self-promo.
Right.
I wanted
this is Checkmate, though, so don't.
And I could have.
Checkmate and Jumbo Sound, you feel me?
But dig that. I got the first day I sold my merch, I sold 700, 800 copies.
Right.
And, my t-shirt sold 700, 800 copies, and I'll let y'all do the math on that one. It's $25 a piece.
Period.
Simple as that.
You had any more?
I had one more, but that was a good finale.
All right,
I'll say my last one.
What is it?
Oh, say your last one.
I'm interested.
Kim K or Kylie?
Kim.
That's hard because listen, as me being Maddie Bidding, I got a lot of people that want to do what I want to do, right? So I would have to say Kim K, off the simple fact that like Kim K started the wave.
Kim K started the wave.
And listen, that's her sister. Like at the end of the day, you can't like that's blood eating. That's blood eating together. So that doesn't matter at the end of the day. I don't even want to compare that.
But the idea that you, that question, right?
Kim definitely, because at the end of the day, she started a momentum. And the thing is, like, especially with what I do, you know, Bucks County, I say I'm the queen of Bucks County because, period, I am. And you know what I mean? So the fact is.
And I'm the king of Bucks County, by the way. So you got the queen and king of Bucks County.
In the same room.
Right, in the same room.
Momentum.
So if you want to debate, hit up, shoot your shot. Podcast.
Right up. Checkmate TV or Maddie Bidding or Jumbo Sound.
Right, right. So my thing is with that, though, definitely Kim K because, you know what I mean? She has to deal with all the backlash, blah, blah, blah.
I was there in 2008 when she and Ray J fucked. I watched that.
Yo, you want to hear about 45 billion other motherfuckers. I'm not lying to you guys. I've never seen the porno. I've never seen it.
Yo, pause, but Ray J fucked the shit out of her.
But wait.
It's still the biggest porn on.
Yes.
Why wouldn't it be?
Right. I personally went to, I promise you, a week or two ago, I can't even really tell you, but around a week or two ago, I went on Pornhub.com and I looked up the Kim K joint because I was curious. I never saw it before. I swear to God,
Kim K sucks great dick and takes. Ray J, whoa, 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 hold on.
The way she sucked it though was definitely not elite in those videos.
No, it's not elite, but it's good enough to get me right. And Ray J was bigger than no homo. I'm a OnlyFans creator.
Real question though, you think
I'm an OnlyFans creator, so you got to be big, and I'm pretty. Right. Good, Ray J's definitely freaked the fuck out.
But another thing that I gotta say, y'all know they were off some shit during that.
Yo, they were definitely off some shit.
Yo, that gum.
Yo, she was chewing the gum. They was off some shit. They was on the E pill. They was fucking hard.
That was Molly.
And it made her $100 million.
That was Molly.
No, 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 no. They were definitely off the Molly. They were chewing the gum. It made her $100 million. Chewing the gum.
She's trying to take it down because it got so much clout.
I've seen clips. She's
like, yo, I made $100 million by now. I don't need no more clout. Please take the video down.
$100 million.
Ray J and her were off the mall.
She's a billionaire.
Definitely off the mall, yo. Chewing that gum hard as hell.
Nah, because of Kanye.
Yo.
No, I feel like she might have touched a bill before Kanye.
No shot.
She's definitely a boss ass bitch who definitely they helped each other.
Kim Kardashian is my favorite.
That's all I want to
say. In the industry, she's by herself.
If I'm not mistaken, I feel like she may have touched a billion before.
Never.
EA, though.
Even with the lawyer shit, though.
Y'all can look that up.
Look what she did with the lawyer shit, though.
I don't need to look it up.
Look what
I follow her every day.
She took her platform and she became, you know, she was trying to do that lawyer, you know. I don't keep up with her too much. You know what I mean? Her dad,
Time out. Let me give it history. Gotta give you history. Her dad was the one that got OJ free?
Yeah.
Back. Period. That's crazy. That's history right there. That's
OJ
already.
OJ is the craziest killer in America that killed his wife for cheating.
Stamps killed his wife.
Allegedly,
but we all know.
And her dad, like, Kim Kardashian's dad, Robert Kardashian, got fucking OJ free.
The glove ain't fit.
No, that's Johnny Cochran. But along with Johnny Cochran. It was a team because OJ was a big football player and he had $1 million to spend on fucking attorneys. So he had a team of attorneys, which was Robert Kardashian, Johnny Cochran, and two others. It was four lawyers that they had on the stand. Those were the two most famous for occluding the most famous. I think Robert occluded the argument that, you know, that he wasn't there at the time, and Johnny Cochran made the rhyme, of course, because he's black, that if the glove don't fit, you must have quit. So,
yeah.
I'm just being honest.
Right.
All right. So, what are we doing?
Where are we at with you?
So, all right, last three questions of the day.
All
right. Last three questions.
The Henny got me. I got it.
Money. Can we talk about haters too?
Huh?
I want to talk about haters at the end, but go ahead. You go first.
Money or followers?
Money.
Boom. That was a quick hit.
100%.
Okay.
Like again, what I said, a girl with 100K.
Money equates to quality. I love followers.
It. 100%. Listen, building a platform leads to more money, right? But at the same time, somebody with 100K versus 10K, the person with 10K could be making so much more money because they know what they're doing and they're a business person, entrepreneur versus that 100K person. But again, me being somebody who's avid on social media, I know that the power of followers creates more revenue. So obviously, it's something that goes hand in hand. Yo, but at the end of the day, money first.
Followers, I love it. Followers is power. But we're going to quick hit this. Would you rather make $10,000 on OnlyFans or $10,000 on Instagram?
$10,000 on Instagram because it's longevity. I already know the people that are showing love on OnlyFans are going to keep showing love. Like, if I'm making 10K off Instagram, that's 10K that I can make every month because now they're going to want to sign me for more, seeing after the capability of what I was capable of.
I disagree. I'd rather make $10,000 on OnlyFans.
But they're taking 20%, and Instagram's not going to take 20% of
that. I agree with that. But I think you'll make more 10,000s. Hypothetically, off OnlyFans.
But then listen. Here, let me let me explain it this way. Now you're gonna come back and agree with me, right? Okay. Sponsored on Instagram, right? You said, oh, make 10K. However you're making that 10K, maybe you're making 2K
flat
off
tummy tea.
Listen, ready? Maybe you're making 2K off Fresh Nova, 2K off Sheen, 2K off maybe a small business that wants you to promote for them. Whatever the case may be, however you get that 10K. That's more exposure, right? Now that more exposure, more fans on OnlyFans.
Boom.
Boom. So that 10K you just made off of Instagram, you could go ahead and traffic that big in the
brand.
You
big in the
to
brand.
OnlyFans, and now you got 10K from OnlyFans and Instagram.
I agree with that. I love that.
Well, I knew you would.
I agree with that, and that was a
and
beautiful
And the Henny kind of like... interrupted that thought process, I feel like, a little bit.
You did amazing with that.
Thank you.
So my last thing,
good job.
And I'm leaving the platform to you. I'm taking my headphones off. It's Tea Time with Maddie Bitting. She does this thing called Tea Time, if you don't know. It's absolutely amazing. And she, I won't want to say exposes people, but like does the craziest shit on Tea Time. So it's now Tea Time with Maddie Bitting.
I'm taking my headphones off too, if you are.
So, yo, Maddie Bitting, Tea Time.
You got the floor,
Shoot Your Shot Podcast. Tea Time with Maddie Bitting. Let's go.
All right, listen. We don't do no free clout, so I'm not going to drop no names or nothing extra like that. But the main thing with Tea Time is I got the most haters in Bucks County.
Absolutely.
That's period. And you know it just from, mention my name that you're going to work with me. So, like, most haters in Bucks County, that's stamped. Got a lot of haters that said, a lot of things. And now guess what they're trying to do?
Work with you.
Get in my lane. Model. Event plan. Whatever the case may be. They have a lot to say, but now they're trying to replicate what I do. And this is what I really want to say. Tea Time is all those haters will turn into fans in due time. In due time, right? So all them haters are going to turn into fans. And all those haters are mad because you're doing stuff that they can't do. And that's just period. Like, they can't accomplish. And here's another thing I reposted on Instagram today. They're from the same area and they're mad that they're in the same place and you're not. And the fact is, if you're on your way to something great, they're going to hate because they can't replicate it. You know what I mean? You're your own person. That's why I believe in being me. You know what I mean? Promoting what I do. So at the end of the day, I got the most haters in Bucks County. I'm not going to get too much into
Tea Time.
So
you're not going to expose nobody today?
Free clout is just not free. You know what I mean? So like,
you ain't got to say the name. I'm just waiting for the tea. Who you fucking? What's going on? Who treated you wrong? What's going on?
He wants to get into that.
I want the tea. Listen. Yo, listen to this.
Hold on, we'll give you tea real quick.
Hold on, talk about. I watched her last Tea Time. And she was like, she posted the screenshots. This girl talked about how she was fucking this dude. All types of crazy shit.
It was a boyfriend. But,
Tea Time with Maddie Bitting starts now.
Right, okay. I only got two exes, right? Two exes. I never really, relationships are a big thing for me, so, like, I take them seriously. So I've only ever been in two relationships.
Big facts.
And me being a boss-ass bitch that I am, it's it's, I take into consideration, it's very hard to be with a female like me. I carry it like a dude, if you want me to be honest. Like, facts. That's just my demeanor. You know what I mean? I get respected. When I walk into a room with a bunch of guys, I get dabbed up because of the way that I am. You know what right. I mean? That's how I carry myself. So being my boyfriend, definitely not easy, especially with me doing OnlyFans, pictures, mad guys in my inbox, and I gotta, you know, show love back to them because they're showing love facts. To me. So it's definitely not easy being with me, but what I've noticed is it's gonna be hard for me to find a man.
It's gonna be hard for me to find a girl too. I fuck a lot of bitches on OnlyFans.
It's gonna be hard for me to find a man that can handle.
And I'll pay for your condo wherever right. you want from my OnlyFans.
You heard that first, you're right here. So listen, it's gonna be hard for me to find a man.
So if you could respect that and understand that, basically, then facts. That's a whole nother level of understanding.
It's gonna be
you
so hard.
You gotta understand that I laid it on you a little different than I would lay it on her.
Facts. So like, it's gonna be so hard for me to find a man that's able to have a bitch that carries it like a guy and basically like brands herself into something amazing. Like, it's gonna be hard to support a bitch that's pulling as much money as you without your ego getting involved.
Dig this. I love that. That was great tea time. Last thing I want to ask is marketing for social media. How do you feel like girls should market their social media?
Again, be true to yourself. You know, post things that in 10 years you're going to support. You know what I mean? You might be 30 years old and they bring up something that you posted when you were 20. You're going to say, hell yeah, that was me. And love I still it. Believe it. Love and that's it. Just how I come.
Well, with that being said, you were with Maddie Bitting, Checkmate TV, Jumbo Sound,
period.
In the fucking building.
Shoot your shot, dickhead.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you, Maddie.
Thank you, Maddie.
We absolutely love you. You are the best. Holla at your boy. I wish you the best. Yo, and we out.
Right. Time for a good time. You'll see it on the Snap and Instagram story, but that's all I gotta say, period.
Boom.
Peace out, y'all. Appreciate you for having me, y'all.